Without further interruption, let's celebrate and suck some dick.
Well, Merry Christmas, chat. I told you. I said I'd do a Lonely Fox Christmas special, and here I am. A little bit worse for wear, a little bit sick. But, you know, that's part of the holiday spirit, I suppose. You're supposed to be a little bit sick. Maybe next time I don't drink half a bottle of gin at the dinner table and then piss on my relatives. Probably not the best way to start off the holiday season, but it's a memorable one. They'll have stories to tell for years to come. Now, I know some of you might be confused as to what this is. LF? What is LF? Well, that's a Lonely Fox. A Lonely Fox Christmas. Decided to do a little live stream for those out there that, I don't know, don't have family dinners to go to, don't have friends' dinners to go to, have a nice microwavable meal sitting in front of them with the saddest looking tree you've ever seen. I mean, why even decorate it? Nobody else is going to look at it. God, it's depressing. But I want you to remember something. No matter how bad it is, no matter how awful that banquet feast may taste to you right now, at least you aren't Spoony One. I don't know if anybody, this has all been discussed on the secret weather streams that are usually at fucking 1 in the morning that Euros and Aussies are watching. But poor Noah. His car gets destroyed. His girlfriend, wife, whatever leaves him. Internet career is in a shambles. And now they're taking his house away. And that's his Christmas. So you'd have to have some catastrophically bad luck to top that. So be thankful for some things. Be thankful that you are not the Spoony One. Now, I don't know how you're celebrating today. I don't know what you've got going on today, what kind of feast you have prepared. I thought I would go with the tried and true selection. So I went out, and I got myself an Impossible Whopper. You know why it's called Impossible? Because it's going to be impossible not to grow tits if you eat this estrogen-filled shit. Packed full of 8 bajillion gazillion pounds of soy. Just looking at this picture is making my breasts grow. By the end of this stream, I'm going to be a D cup. I'm going to be the prettiest girl in town. And they're not going to be able to take their eyes off of me. But I've got that delicious soy burger waiting for me. And of course, who could forget? Need a little something to wash it down. Only the finest of drinks. A little Franzia. Franzia is like the Shasta of wine. If you go to somebody's place and they say, hey, would you like some wine? And you say, yeah, I'd love some wine. And they say, well, here's some Franzia. You know that person is either on the verge of becoming homeless or they fucking hate you. It's like offering somebody a Zima. It's really not the way to go. Now I've got some, I've got a little mood music. It's a holiday season. It's a festive season. I've got this somewhere set up here. Put this in the background. Make sure we got the levels going well. Just nice and low. There we go. See how nice that is? Hopefully the volume's not completely fucked on that. I'm sure you'll all scream at me if it is. It should be nice, quiet background music. It's nice and relaxing. You want something pleasant to listen to as you enjoy your fancy feast. Well, no, fancy feast would be cat food. I mean, if you're feeling ballsy, by all means, dig into some fancy feast. But usually here, we're going to go with, we're going to go with banquet, I think. And I'm going to turn that to just a tad more. Just so it's just completely in the background. I'm not good with this editing shit. There we go. Let's try that. Maybe that'll be better. Should be like a whisper. It's the ASMR of Christmas music. You could just barely hear it. I think we got it. I'm waiting for chat to catch up so I can make sure that I have the settings properly adjusted. By all means, feel free to scream about it. Can we get a Tim Pool year in review, chat? I don't know. I mean, Tim Pool year in review is just reviewing one video, isn't it? I mean, it's just him sitting in the left bottom corner with a news article up on screen telling you the Civil War is coming. I mean, I can't really make fun of him too much for that because I literally just did a video talking about that myself. But that's your year in review. Tim Pool has made the same video 582 times in a row. And it's amazing. I can't fault him on consistency. Tim's out there getting it done. There's your year in review. And didn't he have somebody show up at his house or something? I think that was the other thing. I vaguely remember. I'm not 100% sure, Chad. I can't tell you exactly what Tim Pool has been up to. I really have tuned out of a lot of this. A lot of the anti-SJW stuff, a lot of that shit. I've tuned out of a lot of it. I'm gearing up to become a weeaboo. I've seen the light, and the light is manga. That's my saving grace. Oh, sweet Jesus, here comes the anime. Got a few people very upset about my Shinji views. Some of my videos, they apparently think I'm Adolf Hitler coming to purge the anime community. I assure you, that's not the case. I do find it funny, they're getting very angry about a particular picture I used in a video. I wonder what their reaction would be if they knew who drew it. I don't have the heart to say, though, because I don't want to cause that person any trouble, but it would be funny. It would be funny to me to watch their reaction. But that doesn't really matter. This is a holiday spirit. I've got a few things lined up. Now, let me ask you, chat, before we really get into this, let me make sure I got the video lined up. Yeah, it's lined up. Now, this is technically for Thanksgiving, but come on. I mean, you know, there's some history people out there, history professors, studiers of ancient times, who all believe, I've heard the argument made that World War I and World War II really is just one long continuous war. Well, I look at the holidays like that. You could really just say that Thanksgiving all the way to Christmas is just one big goddamn holiday. You're eating the same shit. You're getting together with the same people. So I don't think really showing Thanksgiving feast is terribly wrong or inappropriate. But have you ever heard of a tofurkey? Because we're going to watch a man try to eat 3 pounds of a tofurkey and vomit violently. Because what better way to celebrate Christmas and our fancy feast? God, I said it again, our banquet meals. Then probably the saddest thing you could ever see is a lonely man eating 3 pounds of tofu that's shaped like a turkey. I hope you're ready for that. That's delicious and lined up to go. Is the music volume coming in all right? Can you get barely? Let me check. I'm going to check this on the laptop and see here. Okay, you know what? That seems good to me. I think we're good. Yes, a tofu turkey, a tofurkey. A meal so vile that you can barely find it if you went looking for it. I don't know why you'd ever eat it, nor why would... Well, I'll say this. This guy's channel I used to watch quite a bit. He stopped doing the videos for some reason, but he would review everything in the frozen food section. Everything in the frozen food, even frozen dog and cat ice cream, which is shit meant for your pets. He'd eat it, and then he'd tell you if it was worth it or not. It's pretty entertaining because some of the stuff is heinous. I'm sure you've walked by a frozen food section once or twice and seen something and thought, God, that looks just atrocious. Well, he would buy it and eat it on camera. And one of those that he saved for a very special occasion was a tofurkey. The worst thing that human beings have ever made. Where literally, I think everything in the entire, it's all tofu. Every single thing is just pure tofu. 3 pounds of pure tofu. I don't know why you'd subject yourself to that, but Godspeed, soldier. He did. They sell tofurkeys at every grocery store? Yeah, it's probably the same one from last year, and the year before, and the year before that. Those tofurkeys have been sitting on that shelf for so long now. They're probably as hard as a stone. Well, they were hard as a stone to begin with. At least according to his review, they were. So, Chad, have you been good this year? Did Santa come swooping by your house, or was it just a drunken neighbor that tried to fit his fat ass down your chimney? I wonder if that's happened before. Some terrified child realizing that the sound they heard coming down the chimney wasn't, in fact, goodwill and holiday cheer bearing gifts, but the registered sex offender from next door, really drunk and determined. As they flee screaming into their parents' room, desperately trying to wake mom and dad from their franzia-induced comas. Please don't let it happen. That isn't Santa Claus that came down. And this is not the memory I want for this time of year. Dear sweet parents. Oh, people, chat's been extra good. Well, I'm glad to see you've all been extra good. Santa brought you ammo? Are you going to go to the gun range with Santa? I don't know if that was really Santa, but it's a hell of a gift. Everybody's been a good boy? Well, that's nice to know. Franzia is a good wine gem. Oh, this man is a liar. Let me show you a picture of this shit one more time. Alright, if your wine or your milk... I'm talking to you, Canadians. If your wine... Well, no, wait. Does Canadian milk come in bags or boxes? I can't even remember anymore. I'll keep it to the wine. If your wine comes in a box, no. I'm sorry, it's not good wine. How could you look at this and be like, yeah, you know what? That's the stuff. That's the shit I want to drink. Five fucking liters. I think this is like $2 at the store. 5 liters of box wine. For $2. You know when they used to say that homeless people on the street who were really, really drunk were winos? This is the wine they were drinking. Because it's $2 for 5 fucking liters. You get a box that looks like it could house an Xbox One X in it. I mean, I'd say a VCR, but I doubt you millennials would know what that, or I'm sorry, Zoomers would know what that is. It's a big box. It's a gigantic box of substandard wine. Franzia's a good wine. Do you work for the Franzia company? Do we have a Franzia representative in the chat today? Oh, box wine, somebody said, is for trailers, or trailer park moms. No, box wine is for everybody. I've seen that shit pop up in places you wouldn't expect, and I never understood why. But they won't discontinue it. They won't treat it like Zima. They won't get rid of it. I mean, I remember, God, Zima was just awful. I've talked about it before, and I'll keep talking about it. There's just some shit that should never be made. Boxed wine, Zima, Crystal Pepsi. Crystal Pepsi is an abomination. Oh my God, you know the worst... again, you want to be thankful this year? Be thankful that when you're having your banquet meal sitting in front of you, chat, that you don't have a nice, lukewarm, room temperature Crystal Pepsi. I think that's probably what hell is. They sit you in a room that's moderately moderate temperature, and all you get to drink, there's no food, all you get to drink the entire time throughout eternity is lukewarm Crystal Pepsi. I'd define that as pure fucking torture. At that point, I'd be like, yeah, you know, I must have done some pretty bad shit to be here. Couldn't even give me a new Coke? You had to stick me with lukewarm Crystal Pepsi? What the fuck did I do? People are defending it like you were even alive when it was around. Well, I know they redid it, right? They did the rerun of Crystal Pepsi because they wanted to sucker you fuckers in to drinking that shit again. Making an exclusive limited time shit. I love that sales gimmick. You release an awful product, you wait 20 years, and then you tell people, hey, do you remember? You know what they could bring back? Fuck Crystal Pepsi. Have you eaten Skittles lately? Do you remember what green Skittles used to taste like? It wasn't that awful sour apple shit. Green Skittles used to be amazing. And then somebody decided, how can we make our candy product horrible? I know, let's take one of the best flavors and turn it into pure dog shit. You wanna make me happy this holiday season? Bring back green Skittles. But keep Crystal Pepsi the fuck away from me. I'm surprised there are people defending that in chat. Crystal Pepsi tastes like cyanide? Well, I wouldn't know. Crystal Pepsi is fine, you coward. I've drank it. You can't lie to me. I'm not gonna believe your lies. It's just... Whew. Yes, the apple ones suck, don't they? The old green Skittles. The good green Skittles. Why would you fuck with the formula? I think I have to import it. I remember I got so fucking offended by this because I decided, you know, I haven't had Skittles in forever. It's been like fucking a decade. I got one, and I like the green ones, and I like the purple ones. I was like, oh, this will be good. Nice little trip down memory lane. Pop them in my mouth and fucking just spit them right out. I was like, did these Skittles go bad? Something must be wrong. And then I read the back and it's a different flavor. Go online searching around. You have to order from like Europe and Jamaica. It's like one European country, Estonia. Now you can get the normal green Skittles. You have to go to Estonia or Jamaica. I don't know why they did it. Why you had to fuck with the formula, but they did. It's part of getting old. Welcome to the holiday. Where you reminisce about shit that doesn't matter. Like Crystal Pepsi and green Skittles. I'm still amazed that people actually... Maybe some of you have drank it and liked it, but I'm telling you. Hell is sitting in a room drinking lukewarm Crystal Pepsi and you're not gonna... And Neon Genesis Evangelion is on a loop. And all that's playing from the show is just the Shinji scenes. Nothing else. Just the scenes where Shinji is on the screen. I think I'm constructing a good idea of what I'd imagine hell to be. New green Skittles, lukewarm Crystal Pepsi, and Shinji on a loop. Ecto Coolers. I remember Ecto Coolers. Those weren't bad. Water Bros. Rise Up. Well, water is always going to be water. You can't go wrong with water. Unless you live in... What was the place where their water became tainted? Did they ever get that fixed? There's somewhere in Michigan, wasn't it? Oh, their water got contaminated. Everything's coming out of the faucet looking like diarrhea. And of course, they have to drink bottled water. And now the new report that came out from the... whatever university it was, saying that the dangerous gender-bending hormones and all the other weird stuff that was in these plastics is like 44 times higher than they thought the EPA said it was. So now that entire town, I don't know what's going to happen to them. It's going to turn into some kind of post-apocalyptic fallout thing. I've been avoiding the diarrhea water, drinking bottled water. Who knows what the effects are now after 4 years of that. Flint, thank you, Flint, Michigan. That's what I was looking for. Did they fix their fucking water? Oh, it's flammable. Well, nothing says delicious, refreshing water like it bursting into flames when it touches your lips. Somebody's saying we're fucked. Anthony, are you from Flint? If you are, yeah, my condolences. Drink the snow or something. Melt it. Get snow and melt it. It's safer than your diarrhea water or your plastic bottled water. They haven't fixed it? How can you not fix it? How many years has it been? Are we on year 3 at this point? This is a basic infrastructure problem. I'd imagine that wouldn't be too difficult to get around to resolving. You know, water kind of being a necessity for living would seem to be high on the priority list of shit to fix when things go wrong. Did the local government decide they needed extra hooker parties? How have they not got around to fixing that? Reminds you of Flint has lead pipes. Delicious. Are there plates made of asbestos? If Flint has lead pipes, has everybody gone insane yet? I don't know. I'm just saying, after 3 or 4 years, maybe that had been something you should have finally fucking fixed. See, that's another thing to be grateful for. Except for Anthony, who, by the way he made it sound, sounds like he lives in Flint, Michigan, which you're not going to like what I'm going to say, but be thankful you don't live in Flint, Michigan. And for all of you living in Flint, Michigan, drink the snow. Just make sure it's freshly fallen first. Otherwise, it's going to be unpleasant. Yummy lead chips. Yeah, there's nothing like lead-infused water. Oh, that's delicious. That's fucking refreshing, too. Now, I believe David Stay, that would be Mandar from Photon, is doing his own very special Christmas stream tonight. He said something about that last night. So, that's something to tune in for if you're still lonely this evening. And David sings for people. I don't. But he does. He will sing you sweet, sweet songs. Maybe photon-related Christmas songs. I don't know. Not sure exactly what time he's starting at, but I'm almost 100% certain he said he was doing a Christmas evening stream. We don't need licenses to drink snow over here, or eat it. At least not yet. But we do need them for rainwater, I think, which is insane, but I don't know what to say. I don't know what to say. I did sing Ram Ramch. You're right, I did. With about 10 other people. After a good amount of liquor. That's true. But I'm talking about going full on by yourself. Nice and discernible. People can hear you. I have not done that. I just don't. I don't have a pretty voice, but David does. So, you have a 30-pound turkey? Well, congratulations. I do see there are super chats. I will read those. We'll get to them. But let me bring up this amazing video. I think it's time we get to take a look at Mr. Tofurky. I don't know if we'll watch the entire thing. Maybe just the part where he pukes and cries. Because he did go through such an arduous journey of making a 3-pound tofu turkey. And then eating it by himself. And I think that really represents the spirit of this stream. for you other people out there, for me, for everyone, on this Lonely Fucks Christmas stream. The man eating 3 pounds of tofu, sobbing in a dimly lit living room with a bucket to vomit in. Really just speaks of the holiday spirits, I think. So let's pull it up. The channel's Freezer Burns, by the way, if you want to watch his stuff. He hasn't done anything in like 5 years. I don't know why. It's highly entertaining. I don't know why he just stopped, but this one has always been memorable.
Everyone, welcome to Freezer Burn.
Oh, you know what? I'm gonna dip the background music down just a little bit. Let's pause that. We'll come back to that so we can hear.
One box at a time. It's Thanksgiving time again, ladies and gentlemen, and today I'm reviewing this. It is the tofu.
Do you see that? Do you see the size of that box? Tofurky Vegetarian Feast. I hope you're ready. I hope you're ready just to see how nasty this shit turns out.
Tofurky 3-pound Vegetarian Feast. $24.00 for this vegetarian.
$24. Would you spend $25 for a Tofurky Feast on Thanksgiving? You could get like 18 boxes of Franzia for that. I'm not sure why you'd go for it. 50% dislikes. Well, I think the reason it has that amount of dislikes is the Tofurky makers found this. That or people found it just highly depressing. We'll skip ahead a little bit, take a look at what's in this delicious box. He goes over to Nutrition Shed. I don't think that's really... Wait till you see the brick this shit is. Here we go.
25 milligrams of sodium, and overall there's 34 grams of protein for the roast, 1 gram for the gravy, 6 grams for the dumplings, and 1 gram for the wish sticks. So let's crack this thing open.
Oh, let's do that.
Got a little seal of approval here.
Let's take a look at what this delicious food item looks like. Wait till you see this shit.
What we got. This would be your wish sticks. And so basically it's just two little things, wish stick there. And they look like there's just two pieces that were melded together. That's fine.
You know, because you can't have any real meat. Oh, there are your dumplings. So let's see, soy wish sticks, dumplings with no meat of any kind, really. And there, I want them to show us. Here we go. Oh, no, that's the gravy. That's fine, He's not going to show us the amazing tofurky? Oh, there it is. Look at the size of that thing. It's one solid, solitary fucking brick of tofu. Look at the size of that. 3 pounds of tofurky. They don't even try to make it look like a turkey. It's like a cross between a ham and a hot dog is how they've molded this thing. And he's going to cook that for 8 hours or however long it takes and then force himself to eat all of it. I'm getting sick just thinking about it. I'll be honest, chat. My stomach's getting a little fucking queasy.
tofurkey, and inside would be the stuffing.
Oh, here we go. This, can we just appreciate the fact that one man thought he was going to film a video where he sat down and ate 3 pounds of tofu, 1.5 gallons of gravy, and the soggiest looking dumplings that have ever been created? You can see on the left hand side, he's got a giant jug of water, which, smart decision. And then he's got a bowl big enough to hold the tofu. Oh, fuck.
Vegetarian feast. It is late, guys. It's been 3.5 hours of cook time, and what do we have in front of me? I have this lump of tofu that is called tofurkey with some vegan stuffing inside. I have some apple cranberry potato dumplings, 8 of them. I have this tofurkey jerky wish sticks, like this right here, 2 of those. And I got a vat of gravy, vegan gravy. I have the box for information. I have a glass of water to keep me hydrated, and I got a bucket just in case, because in the grand tradition of...
Yeah, I'm going to spoiler alert that for you. He uses the bucket. Not that it would be a surprising. Let's take a look at the first delicious bite of the shit turkey.
Be this way, so you get a cross-section of it. They say that the best way to prepare it is to actually slice pieces of turkey, or tofurkey, much like you would a turkey. So I'm going to take this. I have a serrated knife here, and I'm going to cut some pieces off, much like you would a turkey, right? Got a lot of this to eat, guys.
And you know, I think it's probably, honest to God, I think it was about this point where he was starting to slice into this fucking thing and saw that it was a solid brick of just the world's worst looking tofu, that he probably realized he really fucked up. That he really realized that he made a mistake thinking he was going to eat 3 pounds of this. Like, he gave that some pretty good cuts, and nothing came off of that. It looks like he peeled a potato. It looks like a potato. The world's biggest fucking potato he's peeling.
And I'm going to tell you how this tastes. Now, consistency, this actually is pretty surprising. It doesn't look like just a piece of plastic that broke off, and that's what I was worried about. It does have some sort of grain to it. Not, I mean, if I looked at that, this, I wouldn't say, oh, okay, that's turkey. Ooh, I'm surprised.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that grain is just sawdust they threw in the tofu to make it a little grittier.
It looked like a piece of Play-Doh that was sliced, which I was worried about in terms of tofurkey consistency. Let's dip it here into the gravy. Let's see how it tastes.
Look at that fucking look. Oh, the regret's hitting him already.
Consistency-wise, it's okay. It tastes kind of chewy. The outside had kind of a skin to it, but it just... I don't know if it was the gravy or if it was the actual tofurkey. Let me try it. I'm going to try the tofurkey without some gravy.
Let me see which tastes worse. What's the worst part of this?
Like most of these meat substitute meals, I got to tell you, if you're eating vegetarian, maybe it's you think this is pretty darn good. I don't like this at all. And I'm really nervous because I only shaved off just a little bit of this thing and I got maybe like 2 pounds of it left.
Isn't he the optimist? 2 pounds of it. No, you've got 3 pounds of it left. You shaved off just a sliver of that. Oh, everything's vegetarian. A complete vegetarian feast. A 3 pound glob of tofu. Oh God, it's so bad.
I think this is okay. It's rubbery. The taste is okay, but that's mostly from the basting that I put on. It feels like I'm eating a toy. It feels like I'm eating rubber, and I'm not down with that. I'm going to have to cut this up. It's all going in my belly anyways. I'm going to cut right through here and show kind of like...
God, look at the size of it. It's just unnatural. It's so not right. It's a solid, rubbery fucking ring of pure tofu. Like some carrots and broccoli shoved in the middle.
The consistency. There you go. See that? Let's get some stuffing into my belly and then see how that is. So I'm going to take out some stuffing in the middle. Wow, that's piping hot. Smells good. There's brown rice in here. There are, looks like wild rice. I don't know what else we got in here.
You know, can I pause this for a second, Chad? What would your reaction be? If you walk by, if you're just walking down the street, and it's Christmas time or Thanksgiving or whatever, and you looked and you saw somebody's blinds were open and it was this, and this is what you saw, was a man sitting in a dimly lit room by himself with a puke bucket and 3 pounds of tofu, and he just has the world's most miserable look on his face. What would your initial thoughts be? Would you utter a little prayer for him? Would you run out and get him an Impossible Burger and some Francia so at least he could have something a little better? Holy shit, that is so much tofu. Soylent turkey, yes, Chad. You would run? It's just... Oh, this video... I used to know a guy named Hack who ran a channel, and the whole gimmick of his channel was he did the world's most depressing food reviews, where he would literally just film the food and himself eating it, and all he would do was sob uncontrollably while he ate it. But he never told anybody it was a joke. He just presented those videos as they were real. Just like, I'm going to review this burrito. I'm going to review this cheeseburger. He did this years and years ago. It was the most depressing shit. And it's that's what this video is. It's just one dude sitting there with 3 pounds of tofu, dark room, by himself. And it's just miserable.
Brown rice, stuffing, whole wheat bread cubes, organic brown rice, salt, yeast, enzymes, blah, blah, blah. Let's see how this tastes.
He looks so mad.
Dry. Dry. Really dry. The taste is not bad. It's not horrible. But man, it's just dry. And chewy. It's like eating twigs and berries that were like underneath a bed of wet leaves during a rainstorm. That's the consistency. Really chewy.
Are there any vegans that are in chat right now? Can anybody confirm that this is what vegan food tastes like? Is it like twigs and berries and shit? That's after a fresh rainstorm? I've never eaten vegan food, so I don't know how bad it is, but I could imagine. To me, it seems like the downside of it is it's always going to be dry. You're never going to get juicy vegan food. And he seems to be kind of confirming that with his... Just, he looks so sad. He just... Oh! God, that is so much... Look at the size of it. He keeps looking down at it with despair. Do you notice that? This is why this is one of my favorite videos on YouTube. This came out in 2013, and I still remember it. This video is 6 fucking years old, and it has never left my memory. Just, he is such a trooper for even trying it. He's so much despair on his face as he does it. Oh, it's great. It's the perfect video.
Just really dry. Oh. Okay. Here is a dumpling. Pick up the apple and the cranberry in here. This, you know, I cooked this frozen in boiling water for 4 minutes until it floated to the top. It's a decent size dumpling. It's got the consistency of like a pierogi, that type of potato pasta type dumpling action. I drained it. It is now a little sticky and moist on the outside, kind of wet on the bottom. Let's see how this tastes.
face. Everything he's eaten out of this abomination of a box that he bought at the supermarket. Every single thing. It's a pure look of hatred and disgust and fear. It's pure fucking fear. Because he's convinced himself he's going to eat all of this. He's going to eat all of it. And just that look sums it up so fucking well. No. Oh, he's looking at that with pure despair, man. God, I love this fucking video.
There's some crazy whack flavoring going on in this, guys. What is in this thing?
what did I just put in my fucking mouth? What is this abomination? What am I eating? It puts it in his mouth, literally spits it out a second later.
Potatoes, wheat flour, water, carrot, apple, cranberry. I gotta tell you, I bit into that thing and it looked like deviled ham. It looks like deviled ham. There's like pinkness action going on here. It had the consistency of like a crab cake, the inside of a crab cake. And it has crazy fruit, like crazy sweet and salty going on here. And I'm really, really nervous about this. I'm really nervous about that. And now this was the piece that I thought I was going to have a lot of luck with.
Okay, so if you've noticed, he didn't like the tofu. He didn't like the stuffing. He thought the gravy tasted weird. And he hates the fucking dumplings. So he's got 7 3/4 dumplings to go, the entire turkey, all the stuffing, all the gravy, and the soy sticks. As you can tell, the video, it doesn't go on for another hour and a half, so I wonder what happens.
I'm going to try just a little bit of gravy just by itself. I had to put this in the microwave. It's kind of a weird aftertaste. I can see some oil kind of collecting on the top. It's lumpy. Oh.
Oh, God, no. What have I done? Nothing in this meal is decent. Everything in this meal is wrong. What in the hell have I done? Oh, I've made... That's just... Everything is regret at this point. He's realized every fucking single step up until this point has been a fucking mistake.
It's okay. I mean, I don't know if the mic is going to pick it up, but my stomach is, like, not liking this, guys. It's okay. There's some chewiness in here. I know that there's, like, little tofu giblets that are dumped in here.
Oh, people saying his stomach gurgled. Let's go back. I did think I heard that, but I thought, well, maybe that's me. Maybe it's the discussion how delicious this meal is. Listen and see really closely if you can hear the gurgling.
All right, just a little bit of gravy just by itself. I had to put this in the microwave.
Give it a snifferoo.
It has kind of a weird aftertaste. I can see some oil kind of collecting on the top. It's lumpy.
His stomach. The instant it went into his mouth, his stomach is already trying to heave it back out.
Oh.
You hear that? Listen to that.
Oh.
You can hear it.
Oh. It's okay. I mean, I don't know if the mic is going to pick it up, but my stomach is like not liking this, guys. It's okay. There's some chewiness in here. I know that there's like little tofu giblets that are dumped in here to show texture or to have texture. And I don't know about that, guys. Okay. This is the final thing. This is the tofurkey jerky wish sticks. I'm supposed to break this off. Ooh, make a wish.
I wish I wasn't eating this. Jerky. This is what's going through his mind.
tastes like turkey jerky, basically. It's probably the best thing about this meal, guys. And it's not even that great. I really don't know what to tell you. If you're eating vegan, maybe this is what you want to do to make you feel like this is Thanksgiving. But I don't know what to tell you. I really don't like this at all. And I'm really nervous that I kind of threw the gauntlet down and now I'm going to try to eat all of this. You know what? Why don't I give a rating first, because I don't know if I'm going to finish this. This is the Tofurky Vegetarian Feast, $24.99.
Yes, Chad, he is very fucking sad. He spent $25 on a meal that makes it sound like he's already got diarrhea. The second he ate that gravy, you could hear there was some shit going on. He's got 3 minutes of video left to eat 3 pounds of tofurkey.
He's short in comparison. I don't like this at all. I'm sure it is fine and perfectly fine for those of you who eat vegan. But man, this would turn me back into eating meat if I went that way, if I ate this. Be really interested to hear any vegetarians, any vegans out there who do eat this or who don't eat it. What do you think of this type of meal? For me, the carnivore, my taste buds, I give this whole meal a half star.
He still gave it a half star. I think it's just because the turkey jerky let him forget for just a minute that this was not going to happen. Oh, look, I'm going to do it. I'm just going to start hacking pieces off of this solid piece of rock and just eating it. It's no matter how much you cut off, there's still so much left. Yeah, dunk it in that horrible shit. Go ahead. $25 for an anal volcano. Yes, Chad, that would be right. Delicious. That's just pure despair. He can't even eat a bite of it without spitting it out. Take a bite, spit it out. Take a bite, spit it out. It's like that scene from Dogma where they tell you angels can't drink, and they take a shot and then spit it out. That's his experience with the tofurkey.
Just kill me now. This is horrible.
God, you can hear it. It sounds like he's cutting.
So this bottom part here is all like crusty. I can't even cut through it. Hopefully you guys will give me a free pass on that one. Oh, this one's still cold.
This is not going well for our guy here. Anybody notice how he... I think this is where he taps out.
That's it. I'm done.
Merry Christmas, chat. Delicious. Somebody said read the comments. I mean, we could go read the comments. Oh, Jim sent me here. Thanks. Well, past the Weatherman comments, Soylent Turkey. I'm a vegan and I've tried it. It's disgusting. I'll make my own food that doesn't taste like Play-Doh. He gets black-billed with every bite. The second you hear his stomach gurgle, that's the warning sign. It seems like people are well aware that the tofurkey experiment has gone terribly fucking wrong. From Gertie Dinkland, Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas to you as well, Gertie. And then there's one for Proto Man. Feliz Navidad, Jimbo. Please remember to read Kengan Ashura for your dose of testosterone. I think I got a dose of testosterone. Oh, My fight or flight mechanism kicked in. Got a lot of chemicals pumping through me at the moment after watching this man try to eat a tofurkey and barely make it through. I love it. I love the fact that he reaches a point where you can tell he knows he's made a mistake, but he's given his word that he's going to try. And it just keeps going downhill. It just, every bite, he just spits it out. He just can't do it. You could hear him trying to saw through it. There's a point where it sounds like he's sawing through, like, particle board. But that's his food that he's supposed to put in his stomach. Let me turn the music back on. There we go. Let everybody relax a little bit after witnessing that. Maybe we'll watch another Christmas-themed eating video. There's always Masiokas. Maybe we can watch Hot Dogs for Obama. That's a classic. Delicious culinary skills. That's not a frozen food. That's a man that decided to make his own food, but doesn't understand how cooking works. So he cracks eggs in the toilet, opens up watermelons and coconuts with a samurai sword, starts house fires, and undercooks everything. He also cooks his bread right on the stovetop so it bursts into flames. It's really charming cooking. Masiokas is just excellent when it comes to that sort of shit. Somebody said, let's watch Mundane Matt. Oh my god, that would be even more depressing. I don't know, what would the Mundane Matt Christmas special be? Would that be walking through a Walmart and checking out the select on... Like, how many times can you review It's a Wonderful Life or something in the Walmart video section before it's just been too many times? I'm not sure what Matt's holiday-themed video special is. Probably better than mine. I'm watching you watch a grown man vomit out tofu turkey on the holiday. But it's another thing to be thankful for. We've got a few things now. Be thankful you're not spoony. Be thankful you're not forced to drink Crystal Pepsi. And be thankful that you didn't have to sit down and try to film yourself eating 3 pounds of a tofurkey with nothing to get you through it other than the world's largest glass of water. He tried to hide himself in that water. I know that situation. You sit down for somebody's cooking and you know it's going to be shit. And you're looking at your drink, whatever it is, and you're hoping, my God, I hope this can wash the taste of this shit down and just let me get through it so they don't realize that what they've made is an abomination. I think everybody's had that experience at least once. You take a look at your... I'd like some more water. Oh, my God, this is the best water I've ever had. Can I have 10 more glasses of water over here? Oh, no, your food's good. The cooking's great. I just like to stay hydrated. I just really, really enjoy water. No! No, I do want seconds. Please, pile it on my plate. Tried to hide himself in that shit. It didn't work out so well, though. I see some people have had some similar experiences, yes. Some people in chat saying, RIP Matt, Monday Matt Holiday Special. God, I want to see a Monday Matt Holiday Special now. It might be more depressing than the video we just watched, really. I don't know, if anybody could ever get a hold of Freezer Burns guy, tell him to restart the show. It was ahead of its time, he was doing that shit just a long time ago, he should be doing it now. Don't give up, bro. This is your time to shine. Me. How am I gonna... Well, I don't... Is it Omelette for Obama? Yeah, but that's not the channel that it should be on. Oh, I misspelled the name, that's why. Okay. Sorry, chat, I'm just getting something queued up. Oh, he did change the name of his channel. Alright, well, that's fine.
Need a spoon...
Just ignore that for a moment. We'll be having a selection of amazing cooking events for you shortly. There are some super chats. Well, there are quite a few. So really, let me read some of these so I don't fall too far behind. And then we're going to watch some more delicious holiday meals. Now, you have your pick, chat. You can tell me what sort of holiday meals you're looking for with our culinary expert, Masiokas. Again, he is a culinary wizard. Omelets for Obama. I thought it was hot dogs for Obama, but maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I fucked up. From Vice, is that the right one? Yeah. From Vice, Jimbo, since you watched Evangelion, are you a Rei or a Zuka guy? I'm a none of them guy. Shinji ruined everything about that show. You bring that show up to me, that's all Shinji comes into my head. Leon and Claire Kennedy. Hey, Jim, you should watch Himeto Umara-chan. Fuck the haters, it's based in Red Pill. You know, people have been giving me shit. Jim, how can... If you like anime and manga, how can... You can't pronounce anything. Listen, I'm not an expert in moon runes, okay? I can barely speak English. Give me a little leeway here. From Maggie Rose. Holy cow, I'm awake for a live stream. Merry Christmas to you and Jade. I love to listen to your whiskey smoker's voice, your wonderfully contagious laughter, and your wise perspectives. Well, there's no need to lie about the wise perspectives. And the whiskey smoker voice is the coughing. I'm glad you enjoy that. And I would call it more of a hackle or a hacking than a contagious laugh. But thank you nonetheless, and a Merry Christmas to you. From Chimera, Merry Christmas, Jim. Right back at you. Sir Shane 63, Merry Christmas, Jew. Well, Happy Hanukkah, back at you. The Cool 4 ID Man 697, Merry Christmas, Jimbo. Black just stole the bike I got for Christmas this morning. Well, that's a... You have my condolences. Hopefully somebody can get that back for you. Tragic Christmas theft. Salty Pickle, that tree. Do you like it? I picked it out especially because it fit the motif so well. Elizabeth Varing. Isaac Cappy sent us. From Reed. Well, I love you started off with a Weatherman song. Looking forward to the stream, good sir. I do like that Weatherman song. From Carnizzle. Here's Christmas shekels from me, Jim. From Va BC Carey. Merry Christmas, Jimbo. We'll read five more of these and get back to the videos. Dove in Death. Not quite a lonely Christmas for me. Going to my mother's in a few hours, but my grandma passed on Friday and put a somber feeling over this year. Going to have to bury this Saturday. Well, my condolences, and I hope you have I would say a Merry Christmas, but at least you've got some family to stay with, so. Can we get an F in chat for Dove and Death? I know that's tough, especially around this time of year. From Danker Than Clanker, building a Lego train to this stream, Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas to you. From AIM Animations, Merry Christmas, Jimbo and Jade. Jim's stream is super happy, number one Christmas fun time. Oh yeah, we're having fun, all right. Alive and well in Israel. Muscle relaxers, rum, and eggnog. Mary Jane and internet porn. I have no regrets. And finally, Dark Dread 2. Merry Christmas. Well, Merry Christmas to you as well. Okay. A lot of Fs in chat. Hopefully that their condolences help lift the spirits a little bit for you. And the stream will take your mind off it for at least the moment. I will pick out, I think, something that will take your mind off of it. If I can find the right one. Now, this is going to... It's going to be... I think it's coconut bread is what I'm looking for. I've shown these before. But this is some old shit. Let me just cue it up.
All right, so...
This is so bad. Everything about this is bad. This is the cooking experience of Masiokas. He's going to be making a delicious meal called coconut bread. If you've ever wondered how to cook food on your own, this man is going to teach us. Maybe you've got a holiday meal you're going to prepare for people in a little bit, and you need some tips and pointers. Well, you're about to get some real tips and pointers. Pause our amazing holiday music. Get the video queued up and ready to go. And let's take a look at how to make coconut bread.
All right, so we're going to be making a secret recipe today. It's the kind of secret people kill for. Basically, it's a... coconut bread. Coconut. But first I'm going to tell you about something I was thinking about. You know, the law of gravity, the way it works, you know, you lift something up, you know?
Already getting some deep thoughts on this? Okay. It's, you know, you've tuned into the perfect cooking show where he pulls out an entire an unshucked coconut. And then he starts talking about the laws of gravity. I mean, that should be your first clue that you're in for a treat.
Like, even if my finger was fused to this, my other fingers could still lift it. So, you know, if you sit down and you put your hand under your foot and you start pulling, you know, if you're strong enough, you should be able to lift yourself and just fly, you know? So I think you got to be pretty strong, but...
Anybody in chat, can you confirm that for us? Masiokas has a theory that you can fly if you put your hands under your feet and lift up hard enough. I don't know if I have the upper body strength for that just yet, but maybe some muscle men in chat want to give that a challenge. The Masiokas Flying Challenge.
Standing, or something. Anyway, all right. It's very difficult when you have a coconut because you gotta open it. I've got this thing here, so you gotta basically just hit it.
Now, I personally would recommend an elm branch, but the branch he's using is an acceptable kitchen implement to open your coconuts.
Oh, for heaven's sake, this is... I'm gonna make a hole in my floor. I mean, I don't know what the guy who invented coconuts was thinking. I mean, he should have... Wait, I got something better. Wait a minute, huh? Let's see. I'm gonna put this...
Clearly that was a problem. It needed a more solid base when you're whacking it with your stick. Oh, better implement. Here we go. There.
All right. There it is. I think I can open it with this.
I usually keep my katana above the sink, but he keeps it below it. But let's see how it goes.
Oh, a little piece got torn off. Let's try again. Ah, shit. Oh, this thing is all dirty.
He's trained in the blade, chat. All right, this man just cut a coconut with a fucking katana on top of his, you know, that's still usable. We'll grab that right off the toilet, right off the bathroom floor. All right, so step one, get yourself a delicious coconut that's rotted. Step two, try using your whacking stick, but if it doesn't work, that's fine. Grab the katana under the sink. If it gets on the kitchen or the bathroom floor, that's fine too. It's still edible.
How fast do coconuts rot? Look at this. Yuck. That's disgusting. I'm gonna clean this thing. Wait a minute. Well, we're gonna do the recipe anyway, but it really smells bad. You know, when you buy a coconut, you usually gotta, you know, careful not to cut myself. You usually gotta...
Always a smart idea to clean your bladed instruments with the blade facing up towards your hand. It's a safety tip from Masiokas. The sharpest part should be facing upward as you grasp the blade.
You know, they buy cars so that as soon as you've got an accident, you know, it kind of blows up so that you gotta buy another one. Alright. Okay, this is clean. Alright. Now for the coconut. Man, it's all wet now. It looks like a little, you know, liquid got all over the place. That's the thing I hate about coconuts. There's always this little...
I love that he's wearing Crocs as he's doing this. I don't know, for some reason that just completes it for me. Just the cleanest house you've ever seen in Crocs. Just, you get down there, make sure you got the coconut juice off your katana blade. You know, being neat and tidy is important. But it's time to make some fucking delicious, edible coconut bread.
Alright, bread. Yeah, pull this under my feet or else I'm going to slip and fall because it's all... wetty. Alright, doesn't blow. Okay, so I'm gonna put this aside. Yuck. Yeah. Disgusting coconut liquid. So we're gonna... Holy shit, look at this. Because I hit the coconut, the stuff just got detached. Wonder if it still works. We're gonna try it. I'm turning the right one this time. Some time ago I was trying to, you know, light this thing up and I accidentally lit that one, you know, and there was a fire.
I like how somebody in chat, their one complaint about the video so far was, hey, he didn't wash his hands. That's what's bothering you out of this particular video? Hey, wait a minute, that's not hygienic. You didn't wash your hands. They'd need a hazmat team to clean this fucking place. I don't think washing his hands is going to be making much of a difference.
Okay, so we got this thing going. We need a plate. Alright, let's start here. Coconut and a slice of bread. The thing is, like, it's like butter, basically. I want to touch this with my fingers. Too disgusting. Yeah. Okay. The thing is, we've got to melt the coconut so that we can...
That's right. You want a nice butter-like consistency for your coconut. For your coconut bread. It's important when you put the butter, coconut butter on. So just, you know, just hold it against there. There you go. That smoke means it's cooking properly. Mmm, smells delicious. Just, there you go. Just give it a good scorching. Should loosen it up, make it nice and liquid-like.
Ugh. Ugh. Damn, it smells so fucking bad. Just gonna get the bad smell. God damn it. It's probably gonna work if the coconut, you know, isn't rotten. Anyway, ideally it should melt, and when it melts you kind of just put over the bread and all that.
There you go. That's our complete product so far. That is what you call coconut bread. So, to walk you through the steps if you joined us late, step one, get a good whacking stick. Don't dehusk your coconut, just whack the shit out of it. Loosen it up a bit. Take your katana, slice it in half, throw away the rotting parts. Heat up your stove. Just burn the coconut for a while and stick it on a piece of untoasted bread. And you've made coconut bread.
Wait. Maybe... I thought... This thing... Some water...
Now this is when it gets pro tip time. All right, this is for the master chef, not the amateurs out there. If your coconut butter is not buttery enough, just add some water and put it back on the stove for a while. You gotta let it simmer a bit. You know, get it nice and nice and juicy.
Man, you see that? It's all like pink here or red or. It smells horrible. Oof. Damn, it smells so bad. I've got no idea. Oof, what the hell? Man, I should be an expert on smells, but sometimes their things just get to me.
Massiokas, expert on smells. Expert on smells. You'd see the fumes coming off of that. It's probably the soul of the coconut going to heaven. Escaping this. Grab a Q-tip, too, by the way. In case you need to clean out any of the gunk. Always good to use. And, you know, just start cleaning your stovetop with your Q-tips while you're cooking is what Masiokas is telling you. It's a good way to get the grime out.
Super machines, you know, like Sega Saturn, whatever. You know, but back in the old days, kids, you know, they could have all the fun they want with just little things like that, you know, and just, you put this little thing here and you pretend that, you know, this is like an Indian tent, you know, and you're like General Custer, and like you go, you know. Anyway, so doesn't seem like this is working. Well,
how does that look for a nice Christmas meal, chat? Taking a look in there, does that look like some delicious coconut butter to you for your coconut bread?
If anyone knows a way to melt coconuts, you can tell me, and, you know, so that's the way to make coconut bread. You melt the coconut, and you just pour it over the bread like that. All right, so see you guys.
Oh, my stomach's feeling a wee bit queasy after that particular one. Oh, there are a few more cooking videos with him we can watch. Don't worry, chat. There's plenty for this Lonely Fucks Christmas special. Just trying to give you some culinary tips in case that banquet meal wasn't enough for you. You wanted to do a little bit more. Option one, buy tofurkey. Option two, get a samurai sword and a coconut and just go to town. I'm not sure what option three is going to be. Maybe we'll make hot dog cake. Chat, would you like hot dog cake? It's delicious, I tell you. Raw hot dogs inside a cake is the best kind of cake you can eat. Read the comments. Everybody wants to read the comments. The comments are old. This is, let's see. He makes me think of a dog somehow given human form and trying to figure out this bizarre world he's found himself in. If you can lift yourself, you can fly. Unsheath katana. The kind of secret people kill for. How to make coconut bread. Step one, take your sword out. Thanks for the recipe. My mouth is watering. His kitchen depresses me, and I'm alone on Christmas. Wow, this one. Oh, it's a new one. All right. Didn't think that's possible. This dude shinobi struck that nut. Yeah, this is some old goon shit, man. I think Something Awful was the first one to stumble on this guy. I remember watching his videos back in the day and being like, that is some amazing shit. This is this channel that it's on is a re-upload. All the original videos got pulled down. There's a amazing backstory to it, but I've heard like 3 or 4 versions of it, so I don't even know at this point what the truth is. But the one that I always liked, the one that I like to imagine is actually the true one, chat, is that the house you see there is his cooking house. That Masiokas is actually rich, no shit, and he owns another house that's normal, that he doesn't cook in, and that he uses this one specifically to cook in. Because he likes to experiment. No. Whether that's him having a severe a little bit of a freeze there for a second. Oh, my computer's fighting against me. Hopefully the stream's doing fine. Whether that's him having a severe disconnect from reality, or whether that's him being the world's greatest troll, I couldn't tell you. I couldn't tell you. Hopefully. All I'm trying to do here is just bring a little bit of merriment, mirth, happiness, a little goodwill, a little joy into your life for this particular time of year. Hopefully that these videos are accomplishing that. I should be back. Should be back. There we go. I see some people saying some things. Am I muted? I shouldn't be. Let me double check. Oh boy, there's been a technical issue. It's time to double check things. Nope, I can hear myself in the background. Mirth and merriment. Is mirth might? I don't know. I wanted to use a fancy word. Fuck you. Okay? I could have said, how about some moxie and mirth? How about that? got a little pep in his step. Oh, good old Masiokas. Right, where did I leave off on this? I'll get through some more of these really quick. From Richard Murphy, I'm so goddamn alone. Well, Richard, you're with us. Watching people cook atrocious things and eat terrible things. Art Scrub, have my banquet meal ready, even though I'm vegan. It's a fwicket, a banquet, a vegan, I don't even, a fuck it. Oh, I get it. Not like it's real meat anyway. Let's get ready for my stomach cancer 2020. Red Target, Merry Christmas, Jim, and chat at girlfriend's family's, so I can't tune in, but take my shekels, my favorite weatherman. Well, hey, if you'd tuned in, you'd be able to cook them some delicious coconut bread. They're loss. I'm going to tell you, they're loss right now. Lifeless Loser, I live in VA. Should I prep for the Boogaloo or just try Battle and Battle Royale it? Also, what's a good spooky movie? Last time I asked, you suggested Weeb Shit. Yeah, people were able to find the name of that movie. It was Hayes from, I believe it was Hayes, from 2005 or 2006. A good spooky movie. God, I haven't watched a good movie in forever. I know Jade's become obsessed with the fucking Joker. She's watched it like 3 times now. But that's not really a scary movie. She just really likes the movie for some reason. What's a good scary movie? Maybe Hellraiser 1 is okay-ish? None of the modern horror movies out there are really good. It's a very weird time of year to be asking me this too, by the way. As far as the Boogaloo or Battle Royale it, I just have a bug out bag ready. Some dried food, a little bit of cash on hand, some gas, maybe, for your vehicle. It's nice and ready, in case. From MySen95, it ain't traditional, but I bought myself a really nice cut of steak for a Christmas dinner. Here's some money, buy yourself some decent food that isn't poisoned by your Asian girlfriend. From Cozy Crusader, remember kids, Iseki is not real incest. Autism Forums, Jimbo, can you update me on the Korsu fuck you debated? I wonder if he's having a good Christmas. I don't know what happened to him. That was the, God, that was from a year or so ago. It's a furry that got very angry with me. It's a Sargon fan, I believe. I couldn't, is that the right one, am I thinking? There's so many furries that got mad at me for a while there that I can't keep them straight anymore. I'm sorry, Autism Forums, I don't have an update for you. From Lum Invader, Merry Christmas, Jim. Did Jade get you Nintendo Labo, or are you already in the club? If not, did you get NVIDIA? Well, I would have loved a suit of Labo armor. I mean, that is true. But we got some board game stuff. Been enjoying board game stuff. That's kind of what we've been focusing on. Try to think of the more recent ones to give you an example. I got the Arkham Horror card game, Twilight Imperium. Oh my god, what is the other one? There's a Star Wars one, and there's one other one that I cannot remember off the top of my head. Oh, that's gonna drive me nuts now. Hold on 1 second. I'm going to go check the name of it. Give me one moment. Okay, I'm back. The name of it is Gloomhaven. And that's... So, not Labo. I'm sorry, if that's what you were hoping for. I know, not as exciting as Labo, but there you are. From Purple Oblivion, I asked before, but can we get plain mugs? You have the SS one, a plain 4 out of 5 one would be great. Even better, a Medicare color black mug with red stars. I think I have enough shit up on that shop at this point. Maybe I'll swap one out for you, though. Honkmania 117, Merry Christmas to my favorite weatherman. Merry Christmas to you. Again, Merry Christmas to you and Jade. That's from Toxic Madman. Kurt Eichenwald, amazing that he's shown up. Hey, Kinderfuhrer, have you read Hikamori Oni-chan, Yagoi Chuck Yu, Bitch Mama to Mezumusko? Are you just making shit up to see if I can string this together in a coherent message? Or are you trying to make it seem like I got a bad case of Tourette's? Like I'm going to just make a title up and see if he can do it. Or Condensed Juice. I'd highly recommend all three. I will check them out. Played in the background. Merry Christmas, Jim. I got pajama pants, Samsung tablet, desk chair, and apartment stuff. Lots of Steam gift cards. Hope we got some holiday goodies. Here's 10 worth. A 10 towards your Jinx Diamond Ring. Oh, well, there we go. Working my way up. I'll make sure to invest that into my Link stash. I've been told if I invest everything into Link, I'll be driving Lambos by 2022. Fingers crossed, here's hoping. Here's hoping I get my Link Lambo with everybody else when my stacks are fat and I'm holding the long game. From Ryan Smith, Merry Christmas, Jimbo, or Jumbo. And from Cheap Whiskey, Kirby is a fat pink suck boy. Apparently, somebody's not a huge fan of Kirby. Okay. I'm trying to think of what secondary video.
Need a spoon.
Oh, no, Masiokas. Let's not get ahead of ourselves. That we could watch. I try to. There are a lot of them, but I don't remember them all by name. But one of my favorite ones is when he washes all of, when he washes all of his cookware in his bathtub because he thinks the bathtub just by default makes things cleaner. So he takes all his dirty pots and pans and puts it in the bathtub, and then I think he uses a toilet too. But we'll see. But let me find another delicious cooking video. I'm sure you're all very excited. Understandable. One second, chat. Now, where's okay. I like the title of this, How to Deal with Kitchen and Bathroom Fires. How? How would you light your bathroom on fire? How would you do that? Oh, you know what? I found the perfect video. Fits with our holiday theme and his cooking abilities. This one's called Collapse of the Toilet. Are you ready for this culinary masterpiece, chat? Are you ready for the collapse of the toilet? Turn the music down here. Actually, you know what? I can just let it play in the background, really. I mean, there's no point in just turning it off and on, I guess. Okay, let's get this one going. Merry Christmas.
All right, just a little bit of an update here. Sorry if my voice sounds a bit strange. I'm a bit sick now. In the video I made about an hour ago, don't try it, okay? Because I realize now it smells horrible, and I tried to throw it away, but I couldn't.
I just want you to understand what you're actually seeing on screen right now, in case your brain can't process it. All right, he's washing his dishes in the bathtub, which hasn't a bathtub that hasn't been cleaned in probably 5 to 8 years. And he was trying to dispose of some, you know, unfortunate cooking in his toilet, and he literally he broke his toilet and the floor under the toilet. His cooking was that strong.
Man, when I start boiling the thing, you know, after a couple of seconds, the smell just killed me. Wait a minute. I'm gonna clean it up a little bit. Damn, forgot to. Damn, there's one. Man, this bathroom is gonna destroy the. Wait. I tried to put some little glue here, you know, like the white stuff. But look at this. The floor is completely uneven here. And look at here. All this wooden floor is all wet.
Can you imagine the just sheer amount of destruction that he has actually committed in this house? He has plates in his kitchen sink, cookware in his bathtub, and his toilet is so destroyed that it has rotted the floor underneath the tiles and cracked it so it's sinking in. He's on his hands and knees in his Crocs, just with his bare hands digging around just to check the structural integrity of it.
And when you step on it, okay, wait a sec. I'm gonna have to hire someone to do something here because this is gonna collapse. I mean, I put some things there, but
if when I walk here, oh man, the problem is that I can't let the, you know, official people come here because I'm gonna live in infamy or something, or
I can't. I love that line. I can't let the official people come. I'll live in infamy. As he uploads the videos to YouTube. I've always loved that. That floor is just a goner. I don't even know how you'd have to tear the whole thing out. What's he gone under the house?
All right, let's go. I'm a bit afraid to go there because it's always dark, you know. Okay. Wait a second, huh?
Just crawling under the house to see what it's like down there. It's just like this is the start of a horror movie.
It's a bit difficult to get through here because I always bang my head on the roof. Ah, man, the smell here is... Now, since I'm afraid of the dark, when I'm working here, it's always terrifying. So you see, all these things here, and I'm trying to make it so that it holds to the floor well, you know? So we can continue that way. You know, if these things fall, I don't know what's going to happen. We're going to have to...
He's supporting the entire underside of his house with fucking cinder blocks he hand-stacked. And he hand-cut to hold the beams up.
Very careful. This is, I put all this powder there because, you know, the stuff, you know, it was broken. And if I put powder over it, it's going to, you know, fix the... The problem, I thought. Wait a minute. Okay. This stuff, I've tried to repair it. I've put some duct tape, but. Alright. So the bathroom is here. Man, when I'm here, I'm always afraid that something's gonna collapse. Okay. Oh, fuck, okay. See that tower? That's right under the bathroom.
So, that's right under his toilet. So when you were upstairs and you saw the floor sinking in, the only thing supporting it are like 8 cinder blocks stacked end over end in his rotting out basement. Just a little bit of powder, some duct tape, cinder blocks. Fucking good to go.
And where I was a few minutes ago, it's here, and I'm gonna put more of these columns there. After a couple, look at this over there. Look at this. You see the rotten wood all over there? It's all completely rotten, and it's very scary because one day I'm gonna go take a dump, and I'm gonna end up here. You see? I'm trying to hold this in place, but...
Any architects or structural engineers out there in the audience want to give us their expert fucking opinion on this jury-rig system? To fix the fucking foundation of his house? I think it's good. I mean, I think this is structurally sound. I'd give this a thumbs up and a pass. I'm sure there's this is well within city ordinance. Oh, I think that was a sewage pipe, too, by the way. That's speculation, I don't know. Maybe that's why all the powder's down there, is to contain the smell. Remember, he's a master of smells.
Look at this. Disgusting. Oh, I'm going back now.
Ah, Merry Christmas. Merry, Merry Christmas. From Masiokas and his amazing jury-rigged foundational support network. Learn how to make sure you're safe and sound this holiday season with at least 18 cinder blocks and 42 pounds of a mysterious-looking powder substance. A roll of duct tape's all you need to keep your house from falling in. I wonder if it ever happened. I wonder if he really ever did take a dump and the whole thing just collapsed on him. He ended up in the basement, scared and alone with no way out and no light. Tried desperately to put his hands under his feet and fly upwards so he can go back up the hole into the brightness. I've got a whole just, I can imagine the whole episode in my head perfectly. Make it into a comic strip. Yeah, you don't get many like that anymore. Good old days of YouTube when you had some a little spice in life, a little fun. Memories lost to time. Aw. You think it was moldy, chat? Well, it was a little bit moldy out there, I agree. It was a little bit of mold. But I think everything's gonna be okay. I think when he put that house on the market for resale, there are people lined up down the street to buy it. It's guaranteed to be structurally sound by Mr. Masiokas, culinary expert of the world-famous coconut bread. Well, hopefully that whetted your whistle a little bit. I'm happy I found that. I always loved the one where he was inside... where he's inside his bathroom and there's just dishes and shit and he just doesn't fucking care. He's just washing shit in the bathtub. Because why not? There's a katana in the house. It's so crazy. It has to be real. That would be so... The amount of dedication that would have to go into making this up to destroy an entire house just to make obscure cooking videos? Oh... I mean, if that were a troll, which I really don't believe it is, but if it were, bravo. That's some high-level shit you're doing. Some next-level stuff you've accomplished out there in Lunacy Land. I want the house with the moldy shit holding the I-beams up. Yes, I think we all do, Chad. I think we all do. Bathtub equals big sink. It is true. The bathtub is a big-ass sink. That's exactly what it is. Since we're on the subject of cooking, is it time to check up on Sandra Lee? Merry Christmas. No, I believe she's dead from alcohol poisoning years ago. I watched her make a Kwanzaa cake that at least had... that Kwanzaa cake must have been 80 proof. I don't know how every one of her recipes involves alcohol, but it does. She was a wine-aunt before that was even a term. How to deal with bathroom fires is the best one. You know, I can see if I can find that one. Let's see if I'll pull that one up. Are you talking about the how to deal with kitchen fires and bathroom fires one?
Need a spoon.
Okay. Oh, okay. Is this one that's like a compilation? Is this from Cooking for Obama? The one where he made omelets and hot dogs and shit for the president and then nearly lit his house on fire? Alright. We'll watch one more Masiokas. Our last one. I don't want to overdo the Masiokas ones. This one is called How to Deal with Kitchen and Bathroom Fires. Here we go.
Need a spoon to, Whoa! What the fuck? Holy shit! What in the world is this? Oh, wait a minute. Wait, I'm gonna shove the TV off. What in the world is this?
Fire safety, folks. Make sure you drag the flaming object along the floor after you turn your TV off.
How the fuck is this?
Oh. Oh. Step one, drag it across the floor. Step two, turn the TV off. Step three, just hook it in the front yard until the snow takes care of it.
I'm gonna put the pepper in, and how do I put down this fire? Aw, oh, fuck. It's not a good idea to make a video when you're so tired. Oh shit, how do you put the fire out like that? Wait a minute. Ah, oh, shit, I hate fire. Maybe with a... vegetable.
He was just making some, you know, crushed red pepper. He wanted it to be spicy. Yeah, vegetable juice will do it. If you ever dump 4 pounds of pepper onto your stovetop, just use tomato juice. It's the safest thing in the world to take care of that fire hazard.
Touched the fire, it just exploded, got even worse. There are some kinds of fires sometimes that that don't get taken out. For fuck's sake, it's still solid.
We're just trying to get it a bit softer. You can put some...
Oh, I forgot about this one. Yeah, he wanted to cook in his bathroom. Fuck! Can you... Just... I don't know. I'm keeping the audio off. I want you to imagine the rationale behind what you're watching right now. I want you to think of how he came to this conclusion. Fucking car engine cleaner, paper towels, a toilet bowl, and I can't even remember what he's... Some kind of meat. Oh, Jesus!
Wait a minute. Oh, well, it doesn't work. Oh, anyway. Let's see. Well, we'll see. Anyway. You know... whoa! Okay, looks like... Oh, fuck. There's some salt. Take the fire out. What the fuck? Ah, shit. Come on. Whoa! For heaven's sake.
If you're wondering what that sound is, he's salting the meat. He's barbecuing right now. Over the stovetop.
On second thought, looks like I need to change the aluminum right now. It's all slippery, so it doesn't roll well when I try to make it roll with the fork. Oof. All right. Usually it says we should put the milk in the blender, but wait a minute, there's smoke. Ah, shit. Ah! For fucks. Ah, wait a minute. Put some water. Alright. That happens sometimes. Usually some water and fire goes out.
That's your Christmas cooking tip from Masiokas. Usually some water and the fire will go out. Happy holiday seasons, everyone. In case you have any of those kitchen fires, now you know how to deal with it. Oh, yeah, this is some old shit, man. I mean, that's the Archive channel, which, yeah, renamed itself for some reason, but I think they started re-upping his stuff in 2010, 2011, so he must have pulled it down in 2008, 2009? So, yeah, I mean, that's 11, 12 years old at this point. But there you go. That's the Cooking King, Masiokas. Always a joy to watch his videos. There are a lot of them, too, by the way. In fact, I'll give you the channel name if you want to go watch them. The Archive has a ton of them. It's literally, he renamed it to Cooking with Hoarders, which is so weird because I could have
sworn... Need a spoon.
Let me see if I can find... Why did he change it? Oh, yeah, okay. Oh, yeah, he just renamed the subtitle of it. Okay, yeah, yeah. But Cooking with Hoarders, and there you go. There you go. Enjoy. Entertainment for everyone. No way he's still alive. This guy's probably dead. Merry Christmas. Good stuff. Old stuff. Yep. Good old stuff. Well, I hope our little Lonely Fox Christmas stream is giving you a little bit of entertainment. Took your mind off some things. David Stay's got his stream coming up this evening. That's something you can watch. Hopefully he'll sing for everyone. Jimmy is... I've just got the world's worst fucking... I got some kind of virus or... I drank too much over the holidays? I don't know. I feel like shit, though. So we're probably going to jump into the rest of the Super Chats and then close it out. If you want videos, I have new videos up over on BitChute. Otherwise, I'm going to fall myself into a coma and dream of some delicious fucking coconut bread. Maybe a tofurkey or two. Some Franzia wine, Crystal Pepsi, green Skittles, maybe? I'm not 100% certain. Maybe read some manga. Maybe go read some fucked up shit. I don't know why people are asking me for horror movie recommendations on Christmas. It's a little weird. But hey, you know, if Hellraiser is your... If it does it for you, let Hellraiser do it for you, I guess. From Sarah Dragon, Merry Christmas, you Irish coffee man. Well, there you go. That's what we call it. Call it Irish coffee so nobody knows we're getting drunk. The Irish are so well known for being alcoholics, a liquored up version of coffee is literally called an Irish coffee. From Kumpala, one, thanks for streaming. I'm a truck driver and I'm on the road. The Kiwi Farmer Josh is being a Jew and not streaming today. I'm a VLF voluntary lonely fuck. There are quite a few out there. You got a truck, you got a truck. Hopefully this took your mind off a little bit of driving. Radio Ruin, Merry Christmas, Jim. Merry Christmas to you. African Child, Jesus ruined my birthday. Is he competing? He took the day from you, did he? From Cinder Archcade, I'm making my wife watch this with me, LOL. Well, she's got some great cooking tips now. Now you're going to suffer. You made her sit and watch this, and now she's going to cook this shit for you. You're going to wake up one night to smell something burning from the toilet and see that she's trying to cook a ham on the ridge of the toilet bowl with fucking engine cleaner, and you have nobody but yourself to blame for it. From The Crack Den, cheers, Jim. 16-hour night shift at the homeless shelter feels better, thank you, or thanks to you, and the lonely fuck Christmas stream. In Ireland, we call it a rogue whopper. Well, good for you for volunteering. Mr. Bear, thanks for the stream. Fiance left me 2 days ago, but at least my brother hasn't shot a gardener. That is true. And remember, it's Juan but not forgotten. Andre, stop avoiding the Kringle question, Jim. From Gojira, have you read Pumpkin Knight, Mr. Manga? I don't think I have, no. From Lum Invader, I spent my prom drinking Hornitos and Franzia right out of the box with a girl we didn't fuck. Oh, you brought all the nice stuff out and she wouldn't even put out. Come on, baby, look at that Franzia. That tells you I love you. It's the season. It's the giving season. You need to give me a chance, just like I gave you that fucking boxed wine. What you doing here? From Richard Murphy, Jim, why does nobody love me? Well, that's a fucking philosophy. That's a question for the ages. I don't know. None of us are loved. That's why it's a lonely fuck's Christmas. From some coder, my sister's place for a big dinner, but I'm too tired and sleeping. Merry Christmas, Jimbone. Merry Christmas to you. Renjunkin, Merry Christmas, Jim. From Matthew Harder, Weather Shaman Jim. I think I'm going to have to break up with my girl. She's a bit crazy but hot. Please pass the Hungry Man and Merry Christmas. Oh, you got yourself one of those, did you, Matthew? The really good sex kind, but completely insane kind? That's a choice. Little column A, little column B, which are you going to go with? Amazing sex, but you might wake up with a knife to your throat. Is that the kind of situation you're in? It's a toss of a coin, my friend. Jet Set Tomato, wage cucking Christmas is never fun, but at least I have your stream to get me through it. Frick retail store that opens on Jesus' birthday. Yeah, it's rough if you're out there in retail right now. Every holiday has got to be just a pain in the ass. Either dealing with people trying to get stuff late, or you're dealing with people that are just massive assholes. They've been imbibing a little too much. dyslexia I have, my girlfriend makes a mean spinach artichoke dip. The key is using fresh cracked black pepper gouda instead of mozzarella. She looks like Rachel Ray. Well, I have been enjoying French onion soup over here. Jade learned to cook that. Went through a couple of different types of cheeses to make it work, but my favorite kind of soup. Good shit. Medicor's Lunicorn Archives. Okay, I'm going to say this right now. I'll read this, but spoiler alert, if you're a fucking nerd and you're into Star Wars, just for like 30 seconds, I'm going to read something and it's a spoiler alert, so you can't get mad at me. All right, you've been spoiled. Medicor's Lunicorn Archives. Palpatine had sex, sorry for the spoiler. Soy Wars Episode 9 is a dumpster fire. I've heard some people had some things to say about it. From Global Shlomo, I recommend Monster Musume. From Black Knight Jack, I'm an amateur game developer and want to legitimately help make your Finders Keepers idea. Is there any way I can get a hold of you? It was a joke. Jay just drew that because of the Finder stream we did. That was art that I was going to use on the Finder stream, but she didn't get done in time. So that's why I use a picture of the guy with the detective. Honkmania 117. As a non-weeb myself, I enjoy seeing you and the fans arguing with Jap cartoons. It's better. Amazing. From a Russian name I will not be able to pronounce. Russian Christmas is on January 7th, so no feast for me yet, but thank you anyway. Sorry about the unreadable name. I'll have to pick up some Russian so I can read these. From Sam J. Woodruff. Thank you, Jimbo, for the Christmas gift. Sucks at work, so the peeps with family could be there. Cheap Whiskey Kirby. He's more than you think. He's got maximum pink. Legato Mati. Remember the reason for this season. Can you lead us in prayer, Mr. Medicor? Pastor Shop can if you're lost for words. Well, I'll leave us off with a prayer at the end of the stream. How's that? From Kratom Pirate. Merry Christmas, everyone. Here's to you, Jim. From James Beckett. Merry Christmas to everyone. To all those who are lonely, you're all welcome to join the Ginger Hive Mind. We are everyone. Sean Turner, didn't a vegetarian sue Burger King? Yes, they did, actually. For the Impossible Burger? Also, can I say your most iconic Naruto and how much you love it? Okay. A vegetarian did sue Burger King because the Impossible Burger was made on the same grill as meat, and they're saying that was a violation of whatever bullshit. It's a nuisance lawsuit. I don't think it's going to go anywhere. From Son of Tiamat, I started watching Legends of the Galactic Heroes on your recommendation. A kind soul uploaded the entire series on YouTube. Loving it so far. Yep, the entire subbed version should be up there in a giant playlist. Absolutely one of my favorite animes. Great if you're into intergalactic politics, but I always like the idea of how it pitted the idea of a democratic republic and an empire against one another and showed you the benefits and downfalls of each of them in a fair manner. From Solvis, Backstreet Girls, Goku Dolls. Yakuza members are faced to take a trip to Thailand for sex reassignment surgery and become pop idols or be killed. I don't know if you're making that up or not, but if you're not making that up and that's a real thing, I'm reading that. That's so ridiculous and over the top. If that's actually a manga that exists, I'm reading that. From Cozy Glow, watch Angel Cop. It's an 80s animu about killing Antifa terrorists in Japan. And a Jewish plot to take over the USA. I shit you not. It's a 6-part OVA, short and simple. From Chris P. Bacon. On my way to my Christmas Eve party yesterday, a guy threw himself in front of the subway train. Merry Christmas. Holy shit. Well, that's going to make some Christmas memories for some people. From Anthony Muscat. Merry Christmas. Silent listener. Tony Goad. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas to you all as well. Errant Vice, I work at a grocery store. Tofurky has the longest shelf life of anything in the produce section. Also opinions on Morrowind, Daddy. Jim. By the way, James Drake at Union Bridge is gay. Well, there you go, I guess, whoever that is. I love Morrowind. Even with the cliff racers up your ass. What did I used to use to glitch the game out and just do stupid shit? Curious of the Savior's Hide and Boots of Blinding Speed. If you equip them in a certain order, it took away the penalty. What basically it did was, you could run Sanic speeds throughout the entire map, and nothing could stop you, and it was fantastic. So I could just, and then if you used levitate and ran backwards with this whole gimmick, you'd shoot straight up into the sky. It was the craziest shit. TKV, yiff me in the mermhole, Daddy Jim, ooh. Kumpa, the one boxed wine has a scandal. It had arsenic in it. Imagine hating somebody so much that you make the worst wine product on earth and then you lace it with arsenic. Why would you be that fucking cruel to people? Rick Robinson, my whole family is dead. Take this shitty present, Jim. Hope it helps you to Texas. I hope you have a... I hope Masiokas has lifted your spirits a little. For my hate Yankees, Merry Christmas, Jim. Buy some cancer sticks. I'll run out and do that right away. Kookie Carls, Clown Shoe Emporium. Yo, Jimbo, I love you. Also, Santa got me a 44 Magnum for Christmas, and my girlfriend got me an authentic Japanese katana. Someone else I know got me an AK-47. Feels great, bro. Also, I have new video games. It sounds like a bitchin' Christmas, man. Very nice. From Colin Lorenzo. I'm taking a shit at a family party to tune in. It's going to be a long shit if you stick around for a while. They're going to think you're doing dirty things in that bathroom, and everybody's going to give you weird looks from every family gathering from now until forever. From Saber Aaron. So what you were saying from the last stream is, you want a pic of you and Jade fucking on a pile of skulls while white people clap, watch and clap for you. Well, no. Though, I mean, I'd accept it. What I was looking for was the Witcher scene from Netflix, where the hunchback and the black guy are screwing each other on elf skulls, and to replace all the clapping people in the background with all the clapping people from Evangelion. There's got to be a wizardry of editing out there that can make that happen. From Sebastian Anon. Merry Christmas, Jim. Hope you're having a great holiday. I am. It's been good. Looking forward to you Twitter divorcing Jade and seeing her post your Oren High School cosplay. Well, it's coming. We're going to take the pro-Jared method and just go full public with it. It's always a smart move. From Nick Gurr, Merry Christmas. I hope you have a wonderful day. Thanks for the Christmas stream and awesome videos on BitChute. What did you get for Christmas? Just some board game stuff. Small gifts between myself and my loved ones. The Mind Corporation. Happy Kwanzaa, Kang. Candy breakfast. Enjoy your TV dinner, potato boomer. Happy Juanza. Glad the streams are alive again. From Shane Frost. Here's some money, Jim. Here's some money. Jim, can you say David Oka is gay? David Oka, I guess Shane Frost believes you are gay. From Krong Gamer. Hey, Jim. Merry Christmas. You have callers? I've done callers before in the past, and it's always turned out to be a disaster. Because I can't seem to get the switchboard thing to work for me. Even when everybody's playing along, everybody's, you know, lined up to do it, there's still always some kind of fuck-up. I mean, I know people use Discord, but I stuck to Skype. Maybe that's my fault. I don't know. I don't mind callers. I mean, I've done caller shows before. What was the last one we did? It was about Star Citizen. I had people call in talking about their donating experiences. I had people calling in and saying they donated anywhere from a couple thousand to $10,000. To get premium ships and items in the back and finance the whole project. And we mostly just talked about, did they feel that they were ever going to get their money's worth and where was it going to go? And that was a year ago, maybe 2 years ago. And I think that was the last call-in that I did. From Jason of the Great Awakening, just showed my mother my two favorite Christmas movies, Die Hard and Brazil. She didn't get a gem. From Joe Rogaine, gonna make Jim's favorite beverage, New Green Skittles, floating in lukewarm Crystal Pepsi. God, that sounds just horrific. From the UFO answer, if you ate 1 pound of delicious tarantulas, would you wash them down with lukewarm Crystal Pepsi or keep the taste of tarantulas in your mouth for hours? I think the bug would... I'd eat the arachnid. I'd keep the taste of the bug rather than the lukewarm Crystal... I know you... Oh, it's hyperbole, but lukewarm room temperature Crystal Pepsi is some of the worst shit you can taste. From Justin Blood, there was this beverage when I was in high school called Crank 2.0. It was caffeinated water. It tasted like drinking a chemical spill. Sounds about right. From 00, Yo Jim, check out Kaifuku Jutsushi no Yari no Soshi. Awesome revenge, Ezeki, where the main character is a straight-up alpha psychopath. Well, I do like those ones, so I'll take a look. From Irish Ryan, a few Jack and Cokes in. Happy Christmas, Jim. Merry Christmas to you. Joshua Day, Jesus, hey Jim, my wife got really drunk and bled from her nose all over our bed sheets, and then she puked. So far, it's been good. Please, SMD, and God bless you. I don't know if I've ever met anybody that got so drunk they bled from their nose. Make sure to take pictures and make a holiday album of it. So every year, when you get together for, you know, it's a Christmas time next year, and she's like, oh, honey, I'm just going to have a glass of wine. Show her the picture. Be like, no, I don't think you are. From, pardon me, from Hannah Smith, Snake Things puppy raper in jail, 31 charges. Holy shit. So they finally nailed his ass to the wall. Well, that's Merry Christmas. What a Christmas miracle. 31 fucking charges. Eh, they weren't fucking around. From Chem Trail Mix. Merry Christmas, Jimbo. Buy a pack of smokes and a game on Steam. Love you lots, you glorious potato. Any plans for New Year's? Not really. I'm not... used to be... I'd go out and do stupid shit, but I'm just an old boomer now. I'm just an old boomer now. I sit in on New Year's and I just feel my bones rot as I age. That's what boomers do on New Year's. We just stare into a mirror while all you kids are out there listening to your hip-hop Robotica music. Us old people, we just sit in the house in the dark and look in mirrors and just watch our bodies rot away. From Stelizy, GTO must be red. Anime live action or weak. Yuichi Yamada is funniest heel. End of Evangelion and Sharp Rise and Japicides line up in this timeline. From Kwamaten, Snake Thing is in custody. Awoo, hee hee hee, XD. XYZ Dude Zero, Flint's black Democratic mayor got caught stealing money from the funds to fix the water for a re-election campaign. Well, I don't know if they're going to re-elect somebody who couldn't fix the fucking problem in the first place. But I guess that's an answer to what happened to Flint. From Joey JoJoJo, my Christmas is surprisingly well. Got a copy of Omega Labyrinth Life, Deadly Premonition, Beautiful Joe 1, Cologne, Samurai Pizza Cats, excuse me, on Blu-ray, and got it invited over to my family for dinner. Merry Christmas. From the De Santiago Brothers. It's my birthday. Can I get a sub? Well, I don't know how I'd send you a Subway sandwich. And I don't know if you're familiar with this or not, but the spokesman for that company apparently molested kids. Should have asked for a hamburger. From Marlene Dietrich. Merry Christmas. From Awoo Patrol. Jim, put the pagan Christmas tree outside where it belongs and bring the baby Jesus inside. Remember, if you're cold, him cold. Ryan Young, Merry Christmas. Tell Susan to go fuck herself. Well, you heard him, Susan. Austin 101990. Can you call my friend Brandon a dirty glow in the... Brandon, you are a dirty glow in the dark. Umpty McDo, Tofuken. Tofu chicken and tofu duck and tofu turkey sounds fucking horrendous. I'll tell you right now. Eric Thorson, let's end the year by laughing at idiots on the internet. That will ease my pain. Peter Waterhouse, Merry Christmas, Jim. Hopefully Jade doesn't work for you too hard later. You want to laugh at idiots on the internet? Let me see. Okay, give me a second. Let me see if I'm going to try to find you a video right now. One second. I'll find you something great. Oh boy. I seem to be having some minor technical difficulties again. Crazy strange. Okay. I was going to find something. God damn. My cold is kicking in like a motherfucker. Oh, well. I will have to do it another time. I'm not sure exactly what's happening. Maybe Susan's dropping the hammer on me. I don't know. From Dead Meme, I'd rather eat a 3-pound tofurkey for Christmas. Got to put down my 18-year-old cat right after Christmas. That is rough. Well, hopefully... hopefully the holidays see you through it. Friends and family. Sean Turner, would you rather eat a tofurkey or a chicken in a can? I'd rather eat neither. Mr. Savage, happy holidays. Joseph was a cuck. Christians, blown the fuck up. From Thieseman, Merry Christmas, Potato Daddy. All I want is a nice hearty awoo. Awoo! There you go. Digger John, funny how they sell garbage as the moral choice. From T.O., Whole Foods employee, people stock up on tofurkey. From the UFO answer, he cut into the tofurkey and thought that it couldn't get worse, but it did. It did get worse. Okay, we've got some kind of weird issue going on here. Okay, it seems to be working. All right, I'm trying to find a video. If you give me a second, chat, I'll see if I can pull it up. Where would it be here? Buried in the depths of shit I watched earlier. Okay, here we go. Let me just transfer it over. Sorry, everyone, just give me one moment.
Hello.
I'll give you a little background story on this just to set the table. Because somebody said they wanted to laugh at idiots. So this guy, people had kept saying that his girlfriend was fake. your girlfriend's fake, your girlfriend's fake. This is a Nintendo advocate. This is Mr. Mason. Mr. Jason Mason. So he made her record probably the weirdest thing I've ever seen and put it up on the internet to prove to people that he really does have a girlfriend. I really have a girlfriend, don't you doubt it. But it sounds like somebody using some kind of voice software to alter their voice, because the speech patterns and everything else sound like him. Just pitched differently. But here you go. Here's the classic Nintendo advocate. I am real. I am a real girl, and I am really dating this dude. Oh, well, I'm going to turn the music down for this. I want you to enjoy the whole thing.
Hello. I am Miss Nintendo Advocate. So I'm proving to you that I'm real. And I am Jason's girlfriend. This is not a setup or especially software used. I'm as real as the nose on your face. Unless, of course, you're Michael Jackson and try other body parts that actually are real. I am 19 and a university student studying graphic design. I have friends and connections on YouTube.
I am real. I am a real girl. I go to university.
Which can verify that I am actually real and I am attending a college. And I am an award winner at what I do. I enter competitions as well on the side, and I always win. I was also student of the year at my last college. So don't say that I'm fake, that I have no life, because I have a life. I have friends in real life, not just online, and I am not a slut or a whore.
You remember that, all right? Miss Nintendo Advocate, she's a classy lady.
Because I'm a virgin, so there. And that is one reason why I like Jason. I love Nintendo, and it's my passion. I love Jason with all my heart, and don't judge anybody unless you know them. Including me and Jason. And that's it. I'm not going to say any more. Goodbye.
She's not going to say any more, Chad. I am real. I am real. Don't you doubt his story. I exist. We both love Nintendo and we love each other. I have friends. They will verify I am real. Ask my university. I exist. Oh, God, man. I wish I could find the Beans for Christmas one. I really do. Oh, God, that's one's lost to the ages, isn't it? I really wish I could find Beans for Christmas, but I don't think that's going to be salvageable. I'm sorry, Chad. I think that one's lost to the ages. Okay, let's continue on here. Sorry, everyone. Somebody wanted a little bit of a giggle, so I tried to give you a little bit of a giggle. Continue onward here. I am real. Who does that? It's so good. From Extort, 1220. Merry Christmas, you filthy potato nibba. Lewis R. Hey, Jim. Watch a YouTube channel named Share My Story. They receive anonymous stories and animate them. Look for the I am breastfed at 16 and my stepdad got me pregnant videos. Okay, let me just copy paste this. I will look that up. Maybe we'll watch some of that. Nope, that's not what I wanted to do. Why would you? Man. I'll tell you, some of the anonymous stories ones, really, I remember somebody did a video compilation maybe 7 or 8 years ago where it was people that, they walked up to him on the street and said, we'll give you anonymity, we just want to get your real opinion. And one of the fucking worst ones I heard, and it was just, it's one, it hits you in the gut. was somebody saying, I have 3 children and I only love 2 of them. And I was like, oh, fuck, man. Oh, that is rough. And the whole video was just that kind of shit. Doc Window Licker. Nothing says Christmas dinner like a tofurkey football washed down with a bucket of vegan cum. Moderator Marcy. Hey there, Boomer Jim. Merry Christmas. Have you heard of the new vegetarian Whopper having large amounts of estrogen? Yeah, we talked about it earlier. Somebody call Alex Jones because they are turning the Whoppers gay. David Young, longtime watcher, first-time donator, and I would donate on Christmas stream, keeping my promise. There you go. Gertie Dinklin, Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas to you as well. Captain Falcon, Heise, show me your moves. Refined Valley Dude, my friend, you are lazy stare Korean eating Soylent turkey. Go back, study different equations, 16-hour day for academic and financial success. I need to study harder. Get my mathematics degree. From Sweetest Sadist, Greta Grubbs doesn't seem bad compared to Tofurkey. I'm telling you, it's a wave of the future of vending machines. John Smith, Merry Christmas, Jim. Having a rough time right now. Been having a rough time for a while. Thank you for spending time with us. A lot of us need it. Well, you are welcome. John Smith as well. Also, if any of you fat fucks as well are lonely fucks, the microwave lean cuisine roast turkey with stuffing and cinnamon apples is great tasting. I don't think I've ever had that one. I'll tell you what a good one is. Boston Market meatloaf and mashed potatoes is pretty good. From Eliza Goldbergstein, go more into Flint, Michigan. It's a rabbit hole for sure. From Solid Carrot, thankfully I have things to do today, but I wanted to drop by and wish you and Jade a Merry Christmas. Thank you for all the content. Lately, it's a gift that keeps on giving. From Tuesday Money, Merry Christmas to you, Jim. Well, Merry Christmas to you as well. From Eric Thorson, never change, Jim. Keep giving us the weather report and laughing at idiots like Donga. I'm not sure what Donga's up to today. My 2 cents is in. I heard the gurgling. It was his girlfriend on his best friend's cock in the background. Oh, you may be right. Protoman Feliz Navidad, Jimbo. Please remember to read Kengan Ashura for your dose of testosterone. From Rex Zelius, no holiday pay this Christmas, only discount cards. That's fucking brutal. They only gave you discount cards instead of holiday pay? That's kind of fucking dickish, isn't it? From FRX, do you know Dragon Ball Z Abridged? Yes, I do. Well, I don't know the people that do it, but I know of it, if that's what you're asking. Hamburglar Aster, Merry Christmas, you lonely fucks. I'm forced to be wage slave today because some people are too retarded to connect to their own fucking Wi-Fi. That's gotta be fun. I want to watch the Christmas videos with my kids. You need to drive out in the snowstorm and make sure. Oh, I was trying to lock into my neighbors by mistake. I'm an idiot. Not a hero. I was literally diagnosed with lupus yesterday. Will you light up a candle for me? Yes, I will. Let me do that right now. There you go. Zasper. I was happy until I saw the tofurkey. Thanks, Jim. Sinek 8. Merry Christmas. What's the chance of doing? Some late night random game streams, not an everyday type of deal, but once in a while, so we can laugh at you. I'm going to be honest with you guys, I can't do that. There's reasons I can't do that. Not just because I'm bad at video games, but the honest to God's truth is, I have a temper, and when I start doing badly in video games, I'd be banned instantly. I can't survive doing that. Maybe if I'd stuck around on DLive, they wouldn't even have tolerated it there. It just is not, it doesn't work. I can't hold it in. You know that clip with PewDiePie? Just imagine that nonstop. Just my stupid opinion. Merry Christmas, Jim. Small gift for a poor boy. Don't go spend it all on Asian hookers. Oops, too late. How did you pull off the username? I'm gonna pronounce it Niger 1488. Did you get around their bots somehow? Clever. Could you play Street Fighter Chode or Pico's Career Day from Spaz Kid? Also, would. Would you make Stretch Douche 2.0 along with Spaz and Red Feather 08? I am not an animator. I don't know how to animate. There's no way I'd be able to be helpful to anyone in that regard. Do they need stick figures? Because I can draw those pretty damn well. From the Chaz, Merry Christmas, Jim. If you're looking for something to read, I would recommend Sun Ken Rock. It's about a guy who climbs the ranks of Korea Mafia by beating the shit out of everyone. I fucking love stories like that. Thank you for the recommendation. I'm sorry, I lost my spot here. Just give me 1 second, chat. Catch up. Make sure to get to everybody's. So listen to our lovely background music. Okay. think, where did I, oh, there we go. There's the abridged one. All right, I found my spot. Yeah, I like the mafia ones. The Yakuza ones have been good as far as manga go. I've been reading a lot of those, enjoying myself. What was the other one too? God, there was I know I'm gonna fuck the name of it up, but I actually liked The Hook. It's about, it's only like two chapters in right now, that's at least up and translated. It's something like My Life as a Villager as an NPC or something like that. It's about a dude who gets to play God. So it's like an Iseki, but instead of going to the world, he gets the power of a god, but he can only do like one blessing a day. And it's him starting to freak out about like, oh, okay, well, how the fuck do I manage this? Well, you know, he starts having serious thoughts about how to make sure people don't get killed. And then the best part of it is, the game he's playing, the magical game that lets him look into another world and play the role of a god, has a monetization system built in. So it's like, hey, do you want your villagers not to burn to death? Pay us $10. Hey, do you want her not to get raped by orcs? Pay us $5. And it's him looking around his room thinking, like, what shit am I going to sell to make sure this doesn't happen? From Digital Documentarian, my grandfather's dog died yesterday. He got it right after my grandmother died. When I get off work, I have to go console a 90-year-old man. Happy holidays, Jim. I'm sure just being there will definitely help. It's tough losing a pet. And it's just rough being alone on the holidays, especially when a loved one's gone as well. Joe Rogaine, look up OK Boomer Pizza. Tyler Knox, if you want to watch some mukbang cringe, check out Nikado Avocado. I don't want to watch mukbang. FREX, Nicker, and then 14.8.8 is a good goy. From Project Noble, happy Hanukkah, Jim. You're the best goy. Well, thank you. And a Merry Kwanzaa to you. From Mariner 1712, Merry Christmas, Weatherman. It's going to rain boulders. Clifford Bates, Merry Xmas. Your thoughts on Fuentes running into Shapiro? you talking about the one on the street where Shapiro is trying to hide behind his wife? Which is pretty easy because Shapiro's like 2 feet tall. I'm surprised Nick was able to find him. I mean, that's like spotting a leprechaun. It should be good luck. I think Nick is going to get a pot of gold. He found Ben Shapiro. He was able to find him. Ben Shapiro is a real-life version of Where's Waldo. He's so short, he blends in everywhere. High off the taff. Or what is that? High off tap. Sorry. Merry Christmas, Jim. You should read Gantz. It's gory, crazy, and the MC is a badass. Don't forget to light up the menorah tonight, too. Yeah, I'm familiar with Gantz. I've gone through Gantz. Always thought the aliens at the end were weird. Oh, we're super gods, man. You're just fucking little ant peons to us. But, you know, they're these bad aliens and we want to help you out. Well, what do you give a shit about? Well, they tried to fuck with us, but you're god aliens. Why are you even worried? Oh, you're totally... You know what else I didn't get? Is like, oh, you have no souls. You're just meat bags. Look, we'll kill you and recreate you. See, nothing happened. But then when somebody said, what about the afterlife? They're like, do you mean the 28 ounces of you that go to the other dimension? It's like, okay, weird alien motherfuckers, you're giving me mixed signals here. Psych 66, remember, Jim, if you marry Jade, it technically never would have happened without Mundane Matt. Oh, he'll be the best man, won't he? PK77, Merry Christmas, Jim. Thoughts on Death Note? I suppose it's okay. I've never really watched it. I mean, I'm familiar with the story, but... We have another little pause there. I think we had another little pause there. Hopefully it didn't knock me off. Hopefully we're still live. Oh, computer's giving up on me. They're onto me. They know where I am. They're coming for me. I still got green. I think I'm okay. Let's check there. Still streaming. Still looking good. All right. Oh, where was I? I lost my place. Moderator Marcy. Hey there, Jim. Just wanted to know... if you got Jade something for Christmas, maybe you got her a shock collar, a lump of coal, or a new cage to lock her up in. Whatever you got her, I hope she likes it. Well, I did get her some stuff, and I hope she does like it. Just another Bigfoot with internet access. What the actual hell is this kitchen? The future. That's, you know what it is? It's a bachelor's kitchen, okay? Ladies out there, if you ever wondered what is my boyfriend's place look like because he never takes me there, that's what it looks like. That's called single guy living. Metacore's Lunacorn Archives. Check out Cooking with Hoarders. It has gems such as My Kitchen. That's what we were watching. That was the Masiokas one, but he changed the name. It used to be like Cyan Cap SA, you know, SA for something awful, but he changed the name of the archive. It's still up there, though. I think it's the same thing you're talking about. Peachfish, Merry Christmas, folks. Also give Merry Xmas by Captain Spaff a listen to. John Jeffries, I ate a hooker's ass. All I want for Christmas is no herpes. Best of luck. And from Symbol, Merry Christmas, and hope you didn't spend your Christmas, hope you didn't spend on your, I think you're trying to say all your Christmas bucks on Christmas gifts. You're going to need it for the next recession. Ho, 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 and frick women. Yes, I love reading Biz and learning that everything's about to implode on us all. Unless you have Link, in which case you're going to be driving a Lambo. But if you invest in, if you invest in metals, if you invest in gold or silver or any of that shit, you're fucked. Invest in stocks, you're fucked. You go read our Wall Street Bets. All those guys, nobody understands. It has to be Link. That's the only way you're going to be safe. From Mosberg 88, Merry 1487 Christmas, Nicker, Disgunding Vids, by the way, Project Noble, Donga Smash, Coconut with Roman Iron Buffalo, I'm sorry, with Iron Buffalo, Lift. Ram Ranch Commando, Merry Christmas, Jimbo, 1488. From Bear Foreigner, Merry Christmas, Potato Nager, Dark Side Dread 2, Alcohol Money. From Coldy Colt, Happy Holidays, you not safe for work trans op, a video was a masterpiece. Well, I'm glad you enjoyed it. From Blood Edge 89, hello Jimbo. Merry Christmas to you. Merry Christmas to you as well. Bloodmark Mentor, Jim confirmed for stealing from crumpled leaves. Always. Dances with Metroids, all I want for Christmas is to have Masiokas on an episode of Kitchen Nightmares. God, that would be amazing. That would be fucking amazing. From Permafrost, somehow I got talked into spending Christmas with my family. Fortunately, I can sneak off to watch the stream every once in a while. Keep it up, Jimbo. From Lurigel, the coconut bread is an insult to my people. I think it's an homage to your people. You should be proud and happy. From Alu Catbar, Jim, what is your favorite metal band? Oh, fuck, I don't know. Baby Metal. How's that? You like that? There you go. Jason of the Great Awakening. Jim, you missed the key step of throwing the coconut on the toilet floor. Fuck, I knew I forgot something. Mr. No Name, just gotta cook away the rotten bits, bro. From Dread the Day says, Merry Yuletide Podmas Weatherman Jim. Oipot Stiven, thanks Jim. Never gonna eat again? Well, glad I could help. John Smith, did he say genital custard? I don't know if he did or not, but, you know, I could imagine. Herman the Tosser, I feel much better about my own life after the coconut bread guy. Please accept this money as a token of my appreciation for the laughs you've given me. Jason the Great Awakening, his full name is Masiokas Rothschild. From Protoman Reminder, that DSP has a degree in finance. He's a literal subject matter expert in money and has been on the verge of losing his house for 5 years. It's been a little rough. Blood Edge 89, have some more of my shekels, you glorious bastard. From Robert Korn, my dad won't die, so I can't get his money. I need the money, Jimbo. Looking for a Christmas miracle, are ya? From Matt Fields, Merry Christmas, Patio Furniture. Merry Christmas, everyone. Pray for Virginia. Also send ammo just in case. From Demon Ralph, Merry Christmas, Jim. From bottom of my heart, thank you for all your content. It always helps during the dark times. Best of luck in 2020. I'll be here. Yeah, 2020 is going to be a wild year for a whole host of reasons. From Rabbit Corn, if you go to another world, Ezeki, and then have sex with your sister, is it incest? Well, this is... You're asking deep thoughts here. So, if you're reincarnated... Well, then, yes. Yes, it would be. It's your sister. you know what? I'm just... Yeah, I'm going to give you a solid yeah. Yeah, it would be. That's where I stand on this subject. Is this a great debate? Is there an Ezeki where somebody's banging their sister? Sounds like half an anime, I'm going to be honest with you. From Wildburn, all hail Jim the Lizard King and Weatherman. From Dimitri, if someone recommends another anime, I will shoot myself. Jim, you traitorous scum. Joining the weebs will be your last mistake. Unsheathed katana. And joke's on you, I've always been a fucking weeb. From Cock Launch, you lied about not reading super chats, you Ebenezer Scrooge faggot. Fuck you for ruining the stream. I'm charging you back. Fuck you this Christmas, you Jew. Well, Merry Christmas to you. Eric Harrison, look up a very Montegraph Christmas epic breakdown. Dr. Peterson, hello there, Jim. Make sure to wash your penis. you can use the Super Chat money to buy yourself some soap. I will jump into that. From Aeronautical Ginger, Jim, the expert on smells, ruined my KFC bucket. I'm sorry, Masiokas has ruined your KFC bucket. I am Medicare dependent now, damn your soothing voice. If you turn out to be Jewish too, I'm going to kill myself. Not a bigot, I'm just really choosy. You're just very, really choosy. I can assure you I'm not actually Jewish. I'm oblivious. Merry Christmas, Jimbo. Here's some shekels. What's the weather look like for the new year? I'm going to say gray clouds are a-coming. It's got a tenuous situation down in Virginia. You got the impeachment on the horizon. You've got Barr doing stuff involving the Democrats. And social media is gearing up for election. It's going to be some wild shit. Peter Waterhouse, Uhara un chin chin gunatsky non dio. And I don't know what I just said, but I'm sure it was entertaining. Cannibal Smallocost, if you want a good scary movie, check out Under the Shadow on Netflix. Okay. Under the Shadow. Have I seen that or not? I don't know. Tell Daddy how big you are. Just finished The Witcher. Thought you were fucking with me about the Hunchback and Elfcock stuff. Also, would Yennefer count as a dead egger? Yes. Yes, Yennefer actually is a dead egger. 100% yes. And no, I wasn't lying. A hunchback gets fucked by a black elf on skulls while white people clap. It's such a weird scene. From the Salesian, Salesation. Merry Christmas, Jim. These streams are the few fireside chats tailored for today's use. The Magistrate. Canadian rubles are worthless, rubles are worthless, Jim. You can have them from your neighbor. Merry Christmas. Thanks for the laughs. John Smith, be right back. Going to clean my room. Now, he does inspire that feeling, doesn't he? Jay Long, Merry Christmas. You are our entertainment. We spend today with family that we don't want to be with. Thank you, O Lord and Savior, Jim. That's right. Well, it was just meant to kill a little time and make people feel a little bit better. And again, I'd like to reiterate, David Stay will be doing a stream tonight where I'm certain he will sing for people holiday songs, if you ask him to. Unless I misheard him and misunderstood what he meant. Arcade Outpost, the toilet cook vids remind me of the Alan Tutorial Channel performance art, Merry Christmas. I think that's way too in-depth to be performance art, but I've heard multiple takes on it. Elizabeth Bathory, Jim, I don't think these videos are very Christmassy. Well, it is a lonely fuck's Christmas. Jet Set Tomato, check out Mansion of Madness if you like board games. It's Lovecraftian mini D&D. Happy Hanukkah, you Semite. Well, I'll definitely check it out. Robbie, don't care. Bob Villa, eat your heart out. Mr. No Name, Merry Christmas. Jimbo, God has abandoned us. Oh, I think he abandoned us after we abandoned him. He took one look down at us, wearing diapers and wearing furry suits and fucking car exhausts and doing all the other degenerate weird shit we did. And he was like, fuck it, I'm out of here. I'm gonna go to a different galaxy and try over. From Meddens, first live stream I catch. Keep doing what you do. From Jackson, I nutted a baby into a woman so she can't drink. You're keeping her sane, Jim. Merry Christmas. Christ our Savior is born. All rejoice except the Jews. Full swing. Scrabble through a video called 010 by Human Being 15. It's a wild hoarder obsessed with Puff Daddy with hundreds of spirals saying, notice me, Puff? Okay, you know what? Let's take a look. It sounds ludicrous. What in the fuck is this? Alright, we'll take a look. Let's watch a little bit of this and see what we got. Apparently, recommendation. A hoarder who loves him some Puff Daddy. Does he talk at any point doing it? Oh, is this the sign you were talking about? What does it say? Mr. Diddy, all this hard I have done for you. Oh, I've done all of this for you, Mr. Diddy. Mr. Diddy, do you see? Do you see, Mr. Diddy? Do you see all the fucking notebooks of my love sonnets to you, Mr. Diddy? Each of these contains my plans on how we're going to have sex. Every one of them. An erotic adventure, Mr. Diddy. What in the fuck? Holy fucking shit, this guy likes P. Diddy. What's in the books? Does he show us what's in the... Oh, he writes it like a mantra. Every single book is just, please notice me, Mr. Diddy. There's no way somebody's this crazy. There's got to be like 20,000 notebooks here. Diddy, please. Please, Diddy. Notice me. Holy shit. Was this just, was this him trying to get a career? Or was he legit insane? Like, that's some hardcore shit. Diddy, come on. Come on, dog. Look at all these notebooks. I love you. I want to be your Diddess. I want to be Diddy's Diddess. Come on. Hook me up here, Diddy. From Nuker145, so what's your honest thoughts on the shrink in your last video? Also read the Vonage Hotel manga. The most romantic scene involves giving a girl a glass eye. My honest thoughts on the shrink in the last video is probably that he was shitposting, but that he was also dipping into his own supply, if you know what I mean. He struck me as somebody that, if he wasn't taking drugs for recreational uses, was trying to medicate his own kind of condition, and maybe got addicted to it. I don't know. He sounded off to me. But I thought it was an interesting story. You got a guy that shitposts so hard, state and media get involved, and people he wrote papers with get involved. And even at the end of that, he still keeps his job and nobody can do anything to him. So I don't know. And the problem is, there were 600 videos that were up, but you can only find maybe 100, and a lot of them are region blocked. So I'm sure there's even crazier shit out there, but good luck. It's a lot of it's lost to the sands of time. Frogstein Shekeltoad, happy Hanukkah for my favorite Mossad agent. Gal Dawson, do we have an update on Corinne? Is she still crazy? Well, she'll always be crazy. Sure, Shane63, what's your opinion on the Libertarian Party, Jim? Oh, you know, after seeing some quirky chick say that she wanted Harry Potter or the elf or whatever the fucking little green thing is from Harry Potter is the icon or mascot. And there was the dude that got, like, naked. The Libertarian Party did some wild shit at their conventions. I like Rhodes, man. That's where I stand on this. Jay, cooking for potatoes. Duke Reynolds, you should read the manga, Frezia. It's a good story about a schizo government assassin. From Lurigel, this can't be legal, Jim, that poor house. From Pakashop, well, I never knew how to basic had a cooking channel. Well, now you do. Proto Man, Jimbo, stop you. Feed Nurgle when you show us this. Well, the plague spreads. From Opat Stiven, Merry Christmas, Jim. When are you going to do a manga anime stream? I am working on an anime, or not anime, a manga video. And I'll be what's up on YouTube. Jermaine Niger, guys, guy got better. Got a new place and help he needed. Last I heard, he's learning how to cook. Well, there you go. There's an update on Masiokas. Looks like things are looking up for him. I'm glad. La Party, we survived on another year. Merry Christmas, Jimbo. Possibly the NSA. Give the manga, Sun Ken Rock a try. It's by the creator of Dr. Stone, and it's a mafia manga. When you see the main character, you'll recognize what design Senko is using. It's a second recommendation for that. The Night That's Blue, Juan But Not Forgotten. From Runke, you should read Prince of Thorns. Ocean Redux, watch Sayonara Zetsuba Sensei or Hozuki no Retsetsu. They're both great. From Default, I would recommend You Needless. It's about a priest that punches the ever-loving shit out of a pharmaceutical company with superpowers. You know, I might actually check that one out. From Paul Berthoft, have you watched the anime Guyver, the bio-boosted armor? No, but I've seen the Guyver movies from the 80s that was live action. They're terrible and great at the same time. I'd recommend those. Breakdancer Express, Merry Christmas, Jim. Don't freeze to death. I'll try not to. Griffin, Merry Christmas, Jim. From Edelweo 1234. Hey Jim, to bring in the weeaboo this Christmas, I recommend Tokyo Godfather, a story about three homeless people finding a baby in the trash, directed by Satoshi Kon, same guy who did Perfect Blue. Thanks for recommendation. From Jonas Traber, can't stand them subway train jumpers, make everyone else late, selfish pricks. foregone. Tranny Mafia is real, hilarious, and also an anime. From Al Quint, me and my longtime girlfriend finally tied the knot. Huh, congratulations. It was an arduous journey, but worth it. I am happy. Wish us the best, and happy holidays, Jim. Oh, well, happy holidays to both of you. From Mike Testa, Merry Christmas, Jimbo. I got no beef. If you hate My Hero Academia, it's not your kind of show or genre. I actually would rather have someone have different tastes. Yeah, it's not necessarily... Really, you'll find I rarely hate something. It's just not to my liking, is the best way to put it. The only thing you'll really openly hear me shit on right now is Evangelion, because I legitimately hate Shinji. Alan Rensky, Jim, I spent Christmas telling my family they have to hate Star Wars and now and revolt against the mouse. How about you? Well, I don't know what the fuck they're going to do with Star Wars at this point. Maybe get one group of writers and one group of directors and producers to stick with a trilogy next time is a fucking thought. A. Lamau, fuck you, Jim. Horus is shit. Magnus is best Primarch. Blue Satoshi, if you ever use Discord, only use it in your browser. Do not install it on your computer. Good recommendation. From Justin Blood, good Xmas song search, Wham and Slayer mashup. From Big Woke, Merry Crisis. Cookie Carl's Clown Shoe Emporium. Oh, and by the way, Luigi is a coward cuckboy, while Luigi is far cooler and has better memes. Also, purple is better than green, period. Well, thanks, Doc. From Omegas 13, Merry Christmas, Jim and Chat, and Christmas is a holiday for children. If you haven't made some of those, tonight is a great night to get started. God bless. I don't know, I'd feel a little weird fucking on the birthday of Jesus. Just that in the back of my head might throw me off a little bit. Maybe the day after. Merry Christmas. Let's have sex. MLF577, have you beaten Skyrim lately? No, I have not. Citation found. Merry Christmas from troops in Kuwait. My unit is only doing a couple of weeks from, or is only a couple of weeks from returning to Freedom Land. Well, hopefully you get back safely, which you should if you're, you know, coming back from Kuwait. Hopefully nothing crazy happens. I know the North Koreans. What is Kim Jong-un saying? He's got a special fucking gift for the world by December 31st. So maybe he launches a nuke. I don't know. Cheap whiskey. Kirby is a retarded pink space alien that sucks. From Bad Nut. Jim, can you recommend any homosexual mangas? Oh, wait, it's all homosexual. Oh, you got me. Steven Solo. Merry Christmas, Jim. Any state I should move to? I hate California and want to move. Thanks for making the content you do. You are a mighty lad. I don't know where to tell you to go. Multiple states are that I would tell you to go to are shifting in demographics and political affiliations, and so, you know, some of the freedoms you might enjoy there probably won't be there very long. I don't know. I think we should all just take over. Is it Tonga? What's that little country that's just off the east of Australia? I think that's where it is. Maybe I'm fucking the geography. There's this country called Tonga, I'm fairly certain, and it's got like 10 people living on the island, but it's got an infrastructure, and I think their military is like literally one guy that guards it. I say we just take it. And we found our own new country. Who's going to stop us? The Tonganese? From Joshi, Merry Christmas, Jimbo. We just found out yesterday my wife's pregnant. Best Christmas present ever. Well, congratulations. From the Cockmaster, Merry Fatsmas, Jimbo. See you at the buffet. I'll see you down there. From Sin V, if you're going to be a weeboo, you're going to have to say what your favorite sad panda tags are. I wouldn't even know what that is. Sorry, I'm a good boy. From Goat Magnum, Merry Christmas. Been a real lonely fuck for 3 years now. Hardest part of the holidays is the time off of work, so I can't bury my misery in soul-crushing labor to speed up the time to my expiration. Yeah, I'd say probably the roughest ones are going to be Thanksgiving, Christmas, and Valentine's Day? Maybe not Halloween. I mean, Halloween, you're just throwing candy at idiots, but those three, probably. Steven Stramboli, I have spoken. From Keegan the Great, that sounded like Barbara 4U2C. Mario Kart 13, my real girlfriend is a virgin. Have you tried blowing? Hawaiian Blot, Merry Christmas, Jimbo. Are the Super Chats finally working, or Susan Wojaki stealing your Neo Shekel still? Cheers. Oh, we'll find out. Kill me now. Merry Christmas, Jim. Would you play, what is this? Would you play this altcensored.com AltCensored.com video. Bro, I don't know what you're setting me up for here, bro. Hey, Jim, Merry Christmas. You want to play some Holocaust footage for the people out there? Zoe Sherman, I've been watching since you were the Internet Aristocrat, and you'll always be my favorite weatherman. Well, thank you. And the Crack Den. Jim, can you say, welcome to the Crack Den. Today's weather calls for potato nibbling. Merry Christmas, Jim. You're the only one who says my name right. And I probably just fucked it up right there, didn't I? See? See, that happens. And I think we're about caught up here. There's one telling me that all manga is homosexual, so I know I'm in the right spot. Okay, just a few more to go through. From Chiselbit, too, check out a vid called Trolling Wannabe Porn Stars Compilation. Yeah, this is up on eFucked. It's the one where the producers treat the girls like shit to see how much they'll put up with. I think that's the one you're talking about. It's actually pretty funny. It's terrible, but it's funny. Mike Downey, thanks for making my 10th Xmas without my dad a little easier. Well, I'm glad to help. Camille Taggart, Merry Christmas, Jim. I'm using my new easel and getting ready to paint a wholesome portrait. Are you saying that you're FPS Doug? Are you saying that you're an FPS Doug? I don't know what that is. See, I'm not in with all the hip lingo. Yeshua McFly, look up Jenna Friedman's soft focus on CR sexual assault. You like it. From Zemeckis Lebowski, hey, Jim. Or hey again, Jim. Just wanted to call Alex a fey goat. From Anonymous, check out Frankenfran, naive mad scientist's daughter, accidentally acts as a literal genie with insane surgeries. Gore and hell ensues. Frankenfran. All right, I'll check that out. Imperator 88 MM, Merry Christmas. What are your thoughts on Initial D? Enjoy my hard-earned union money. I don't have thoughts yet on that. Anime Justice hold on, let me make sure if I'm thinking of the right thing here. One second. Oh, the driving app? No, I haven't. Okay, now I know what it is. I haven't actually watched it. I'll watch some episodes and then report back. I've got such a backlog now because people over on the anime list thing have been giving me so many fucking recommendations. I'm gonna be a busy boy until 2022 at this rate. Anime Justice Posse. Merry Christmas, Jim. And the Pokemon pedo is back. Doc Window Licker just found out my mom is a no actual racist and despises my Filipino wife and my kids. Merry Christmas to me. Well, that's what the holiday seasons are for. Relatives getting drunk and telling you what they really think. And then feeling awful the next day and trying to awkwardly apologize and pretend it was a mistake. From Booty Bandit, Merry Christmas, Papa Jim. Mr. Demento, I'm going to fuck Jade so hard. Her big tits hit her in the face and knock her out. My baby is your gift, cuckboy. Oh, well, we've been blessed. Thank you, Santa. From Blue Satoshi, it's pronounced Asekai, not Aseki. You can't tell me how to say nothing. Dr. Peterson, I just remembered only 6 days until India is a superpower. Are they going to blast off in outer space? Markatroids. Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas, Ardnapple Negger. Thanks for the skeleton manga recommendation. I enjoyed it a lot. Also, have you seen Code Geese? Yes, I have. Legatomati, playing Baldur's Gate, Bayonetta 3 demos coming out. Merry Xmas, what's your thought on Fooly Cooly? I think everybody's seen that. That's another one that was like on Adult Swim for the longest time. Smoke Fumas, side note, cheap but good wine comes in boxes. Isabel, Carbonet, both mature quickly, no reason to waste glass on it when you move them by the barrel. From Pizza, I like that, Spider Aseki, Manga Boomers Unite. Well, I'm glad you enjoyed it. Herb Loza, here's my 2 shekels, Jimbo, Merry Christmas. The JCO. Yo, Jim, did you see the 400-page manifesto some stalker of some Twitch thought? Look up the Not Angelic. You know, that happened to an SP poster. Somebody, am I remembering this right? Who was the fucking psychopath that was, like, stalking a trip? He wrote, like, hundreds of pages about how he wanted to live a life together. Kind of reminds me of that. Overman, thank you for your videos. Merry Christmas, Jim. Happy New Year. Same to you. The Choker, ha ha ha. Can you tell my girlfriend Sam that she's a bad girl? Sam, you are a bad girl. Your voice makes her wet, and I need to get laid. Thanks for the laughs. Through the years, Merry Christmas. Sam, your boyfriend also wanted you to know this. He put this in parentheses on the super chat asking that I really explain in detail, but his deepest sexual fantasy and desire, Sam, is that you shove a fist up his ass. Now, he's going to pretend like that's not what he wants, but it is. And he's recommending you use the Crisco brand to get lubed up to be able to do it. And when you do it, he wants you to shout, Merry Christmas. There you go. The Joe B. Green. If you want something weird, try Vanilla Spider. Mario Kart 13. Diddle Me. Papa Diddy. Lou Raquel, those notebooks. Is this the cause of climate change? It could be. That was enough trees cut down to make it happen. Metacore's Lunicorn Archives. All work and no play makes Diddy a full diddler. Jason of the Great Awakening. Glad someone brought Kareen up. Jesus told me she's my third wife. Well, there you are. Cecil says, is adult content or adult only content? Is manga like Japanimation, but on paper? Yes. No. Japanimation. But yeah, it's an entertaining read. Yeah, see, chat agrees. Sam, we're all looking forward to you giving him that Christmas gift he's been looking forward to. Peter Waterhouse. So I just ran into this crazy crippled dude. He keeps shouting 111 and 0, and Jim knows what's going on. I'm kind of concerned. He looks pretty messed up. Keep your distance. Got to stay safe. Joey Jojo, Guyver 2-star David Hayter. Jalama? Hey, Jim. Try Half Prince. It's a good Chinese manga. Where do you see anti-BSD laws going? Anti-BSD? What is that? Let me see here. I don't know what an anti-BSD... I legit don't know what an anti-BSD law is. Chat, can you, somebody in chat, help me? What is is it an acronym? What does it stand for? Ocean Redux, I can't believe you're actually fucking pronouncing these correctly. Also, Shinji is fucking awful. Fight me. Lol, Merry Christmas. Legato Mati, can you say, not the whole shampoo bottle, Daddy? It's too big. In a sexy voice. Oh, not the whole shampoo bottle, Daddy. It's too big. There you go. Ronson, just got back home from Star Wars. My favorite part was... Okay, spoiler alert. 3, 2, 1. When Rey killed Chewbacca. From Al Quint, you should read, watch Kakegurui. It's good crazy. Nathan, watch The Lighthouse. Anal Messiah. Merry fuckmas, Jim. Have some more liquor money from Anal Santa. By the way, what's your opinion on the Hyperdimension Neptunia franchise? I never had a chance to get into it. I think I bought one or two of the games, but I never got around to playing them. Dustin D. Hayes, Google search Jesus Christ grave in Japan. It'll make your day. From Kuro 13, read Prunus Girl. It's cute. We all working on a Christmas master race. T. Scott 07, stop crying like a biatch and get in the fucking mech, Shinji. Merry Christmas to you all. I think we are mostly caught up now. Some more people just talking shit about Shinji. Mike Testa, Jim, I know you would love Gellion. It's just a second you realize Shinji would be a thing. The first thing you said was, let me out of here. I want off. Big Dibber Nick. Read Uzumaki by Junji Ito. Jimbo, shit's fucked. Tyler Knox, favorite Spurg out of the decade. This counts Kumite in the kill streams. I don't know. That's like a New Year's question. I have to think on it to give a realistic answer. Kivoski. Merry Krimbus, Jim. Have you played... Nier Automata, thoughts if so? Yeah, I did play it, and I liked it. I thought it was fun. And I liked the first Nier, too. Siren Head, hi, Jim. Is YouTube near its end? It's definitely in the gasping stage. Mike Testa, we watching more funny stuff? Junji Ito anime sucks. It's a different opinion, I guess. 41 Solstice 25, Lonely Fucks Christmas Group, One Buffs Supporter Build. David H., working 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. at a lumberyard, at least got one battery... hard portable TV from my dad last night. Hey, there you go. From Jackboy. Merry Christmas, Jim. Do you know of any manga with a D&D vibe to it? I like Skeleton FTPTD. Also, I hope Jade isn't cooking today. You could try... there's another... I think it's Korean. The beginning after the end about King Gray. It's kind of got a D&D vibe. Well, not really. It's just good. You might not like the art style when it starts out, but it's not bad. It's like, it's an Iseki where it's not from, like, normal world. It's from one fantasy world to another fantasy world, but he goes from one where everybody uses, like, fighting skills, like, DBZ shit, and then he goes to a world that just uses magic, but he reincarnates as a kid, and it's not bad. It's not bad. He fucks some people up pretty bad. A lot of violence in it once you get a little later on in. Tell Daddy how big you are. Isekai Jimbo. Cheap whiskey. Kirby likes his girls, BBW, to eat some lunch with him. From Chodiner, enjoy my hard-earned money, Jimbone, and Merry Christmas. And Tira X Pyra, I live a country away from my girlfriend, and most of my family are JWs, Jehovah Witnesses, so no Christmas for me. Have some shekels, Jimbo. Hope your Christmas is better than mine. Well, hopefully your holiday gets better for you. And finally, Nerdbane, watch Redline. It's wacky, races meets F-Zero. Redline, I've seen that. I've actually seen that. And Nohara Kun, Merry Christmas, Jim. My girl and I are listening to German Christmas music and drinking schnapps. Can't send you booze or ham, so here, buy a Natty Light. Thank you very much. All right. Well, I hope you all have a decent holiday. I hope you've enjoyed eating your Hungry Man meals with us as we've listened to some Christmas music and watched some awful tofurkey eating and how not to support the foundation of your house using cinder blocks and fucking dust. But it could always be worse. No matter how bad it is, it could always be worse. And there's always somebody out there that has it much rougher than you do. So that is at least something to be thankful for, that you are not them. And like somebody said earlier, what's his name? The furry pedophile guy? He's in jail, 31 counts, was that what it was? So there's your Christmas miracle. 31 counts in jail on Christmas. I hope you all have a wonderful holiday. Again, I'm gonna keep plugging David Stay, State of Mind. I love me some Mandar, and hopefully he sings for everyone. Enjoy the rest of your Christmas. I hope you all have a great New Year's. I did promise somebody earlier that I would. I'd give you a prayer at the end. Is that what you wanted? Let me give you a heartfelt Christmas prayer as you hunker over your banquet Salisbury steak. Rub-a-dub-dub. Thanks for the grub. Yay, God. Amen. Oh, see, I timed that perfectly with that music. Oh, perfectly. Come on. Come on. Perfectly with that music. All right, let me see if I can find us a nice outro song. There was a song somebody recommended before. Oh, you know, I'm going to play this just because it's going to annoy people. I think this is what we'll play it out on. Again, thank you for spending a little time. Hope it made your day a little brighter. Hope the holidays go well for you. Have a good New Year's. Be safe. Be smart. Don't go, do something crazy. And the roads are slippery at this time of year. If you're going to drink your Franzia box wine, do it safely. Do it safely.